Alongside Caroline Saunders, Cody Spoon, I'm Jeff Ellison, speaking to you from Jack Stewart Field on the campus of Sachs High School. And tonight, they're playing for all the marbles in Class 4A Region 6 as the Wildcats of Sachs host the Tigers of Cleburne County. These, the top two teams in Region 6 of the 4A classification. And no doubt about it, yes, it's a cliche, Cody, but it's all on the line here tonight.
No doubt about it, Jeff. Sachs coming in at 6-1. Both these teams, Cleburne County 6-1. Both of these teams lost game one of the season. As you said, both coming in 5-0 in region play. And I don't know that we've broadcast a bigger game so far this year. And it looks to be a great matchup here tonight for another great night of Friday night football.
Yeah, you mentioned the fact that both these teams lost their season opener. I don't know how many times. I mean, I've been around the game of football for many years, but so many championships, state championships, region championships, are won by teams that lose their season opener. It's kind of an awakening, I guess, when you walk out on the field after weeks of practice and you get out there and you lose your first game, and then on the heels of that, you seem to go to work. And that's what apparently these two teams have done.
And I feel like early in the season, Jeff, you learn something about yourself. If you lose a game early, I mean, you look at it, Walter Welborn defeated Sachs early in the season 21-20, and Cleburne County was defeated by Mumford 41-28. And since then, both of these teams have been on a tear. Offensively, they're very sound defensively. And I think losing like that early in the year, it gives your coaches something to build off of. It gives your team something to look back at. You don't really want to, you know, be focused on the past, but you can look back at some of the mistakes you made and realize that you've cleaned a lot up and you're moving forward through the second half of the season into the playoffs.
And this is the time of year where you want your team to be playing their best football of the year. And I think that can be said for both these teams here tonight.
You're right, Jeff. This is one of those times it's critical to play your best football. For these two teams, they're locked into the playoff picture, but we've got a lot of teams that are battling for third and fourth place in their regions, and right now you want to play your best football. You want to put together a complete football game in all three phases and come out of your game with a win and lock up a playoff spot.
And we've talked about it, but these teams are so identical. I mean, they love to run the football. Both these teams do. We talked about their records, 6-1. Overall, they both lost their first game of the year. They're 5-0 in region play. I mean, hey, they both wear red as far as their team colors are concerned, but just so identical. Got great coaches, of course, for the Cleburne County Tigers. It's Michael Short in his 18th year, and for Sachs, Jonathan Miller now in his fourth year. I mean, it's just two outstanding programs.
And, Jeff, this is two teams on offense for both of these teams. Cleburne County, they've scored 258 points this year, which is an average of 36.8 points per game. And for Sachs, they've scored 282 points so far in the year, and that's 40.3 points per game. Both of these teams on defense, Cleburne County is only allowing 15.4 points per game, and Sachs is allowing an even 16 points per game. So if you look at it, even on the stat sheet, this is one of the most balanced games we've had, two of the better teams we've had, and it's kind of a coin flip as to who's going to come out on this one the victor.
Yeah, we expected to go deep into the fourth quarter before this one is decided here this evening. And speaking of good teams and great programs, a week ago here on FNN, we witnessed the Piedmont Bulldogs with yet another win, and that's another team that's playing a good football right now. I think we have some highlights from last week's game as Piedmont defeated Welborn, that game being played at the Field of Champions. And Piedmont in that one, Cody, they just really control that contest from the get-go.
Darnell Jackson had yet another big night for this Piedmont team. This team, early in the year, some might have said they had a few things to work out, but they are playing great football since that loss at Leeds. And this is just a really good football team out of Calhoun County. And we expect to see them go deep in the playoffs. As there you see Darnell Jackson power into the end zone. Taylor Hayes, your starting quarterback, he's a leader on this team. And you see some of the plays. Piedmont able to do it on the ground and in the air last week as they get a huge region win, and they've sit clearly in the driver's seat in their region in Class 3A.
Again, Piedmont defeating Welborn last week. They're playing Westbrook Christian here this evening. That game played at the Field of Champions. But back here at Jack Stewart Field, as you can see, it is senior night, the final home game of the year, regular season home game of the year here at Sachs. We'll step aside, take a break, and we'll be back with more on the Friday Night Network.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama. We're still first, and so are you.
Now what?
Let's go. That way.
Have fun out there on the compact, capable, and entirely new Pioneer 500 from Honda.
Visit Cycle World in Gadsden today or online at cycleworldonline.com.
Well, hey, you got one of those insurance apps, too? You know how this thing works?
No, sorry. Not an app. It's my agent.
In this moment...
No, I'm fine. Thanks.
It's good to know you have a trusted, independent auto owner's insurance agent who's there when you need them.
Great. Man, I gotta get one of those.
Auto owner's insurance. The no problem people.
Calhoun Insurance in Oxford is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
Need a place to keep your tools?
Or a place to get away from the wife. Whatever your needs are, we got a barn or a carport for you.
With rent-to-own options and no credit checks, we can help you take home the right barn or carport today.
And with four different locations, we're just a short drive away.
So come see us in Glen Cove, Moody, Asheville, or Atala, and let our family help your family get the barn or carport you deserve.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
Jack Stewart Field, just off Highway 431. The location tonight, the site for Sachs and Cleburne County this evening for the Class 4A Region 6 Championship. Jack Stewart, former coach here at Sachs. Coached for 12 years from 1966 to 77. A lot of people give Coach Stewart credit for kind of putting Sachs football on the map here in this area. A lot of big games in the area tonight. This is not the only big one, and we'll take a look at some of those right now. And there you see Alexandria at Moody this evening, that game being played at Bill Morris Stadium. And the Cubs, the Valley Cubs, are really, as you see, they're riding a wave of success, a big win a week ago, and they are on a roll, Cody.
The Valley Cubs are great on offense, explosive offense, really good on the ground. They're playing great defense. As you can see, they're on the verge of winning a region title, and they're looking for that undefeated season. They have been playing great football, and that's a team to look for to go deep in the playoffs this year in 2015.
A year ago, those two teams played, and they combined for 101 points. Alexandria defeating Moody a year ago, 64-37. Moving on with other games, and there you see Realtown at Randolph County this evening. And again, this Randolph County team looking to go perfect and end the season without a loss, and they've got a very good chance to do just that.
And you know, Realtown is hungry for that. They want to make sure that Randolph County doesn't have a perfect season. It'll be interesting to see how this game goes tonight. Randolph County for sure has to be kind of a favorite in that ball game.
Yeah, Randolph County, as you said, playing at home in Wedowee, you would expect them to win that ball game. Down in Talladega County tonight, down at Bulldog Stadium, Winneboro is hosting TC Central. This is a rivalry there in Talladega County, regardless of the sport. And again, TC and the Bulldogs playing tonight in a big 1A game.
Winterboro, Coach Alan Beckett in Winterboro had a huge win last week over Victory Christian. They go into this ball game with some momentum. They're playing for a playoff spot, and that one should be a great matchup, as you said, a rivalry game, and leave it all on the table there.
Yeah, TCC getting off to a slow start, but really playing some good football here in recent weeks. And Pell City on the road tonight at Chelsea, that game at Richard Kunkel Stadium. And, you know, Oxford fans, well, you know, last week they defeated Pell City, and now they just kind of turn around and they suddenly become Pell City Panther fans tonight.
They're looking at Pell City to help them get into the playoffs. And Chelsea, they got to shake off these past few weeks. They lost at home to Opelika. They lost to Benjamin Russell. So they've got to get back on track after two straight losses. That's something tough to do if you're a head coach, but that right there should be a great football game.
It should be in Class 6A. And moving on, Wadley at Victory Christian this evening. Victory Christian last week, well, they were upset by Winterboro to the surprise of many. And now Wadley comes in, and another quality ball club there from Randolph County. And Wadley and Victory Christian, that game being played there in Pell City.
If Wadley can win this ball game, they will remain in the mix for the title hunt. And there you see Victory Christian. If they can pull off this upset, they will also remain in the mix. And that makes the next week's game for Wadley versus Winterboro a huge matchup.
And moving on, again, as we're looking at a number of big games this week, and on FNN2 this evening, it is Glencoe at Weaver. You see Glencoe coming in with just one loss on the year, and of course they're right in there behind Piedmont. And Weaver, yeah, they're 4-3, and still, you know, they are got a very good chance to move up in the region if they can win out.
The Yellow Jackets, a strong team this year in 2015. You expect nothing less out of Coach Osmond and his Yellow Jackets. And Weaver, as we said, they control their destiny here. There's a lot of scenarios that could put them in there for the region title, but they're going to have a strong showing here over the next two ball games to do something in that region.
And there you see Region 6 in Class 3A. Piedmont, a team we saw a week ago. They're in the driver's seat, as you see right there, followed by Glencoe, of course. And the tiebreaker there, if Piedmont would win that tiebreaker head-to-head over Glencoe. And as we said, you know, Weaver kind of controls their own destiny. It's kind of strange to say that. They sit in there at the number three slot, but still, when you've got teams ahead of you that you've just got to win, that's what Weaver is facing right now if they want to kind of improve their position as far as postseason play is concerned. And Westbrook Christian still with an outside chance as well. And tonight they're playing Piedmont. And our game here this evening, I mean, so much on the line here this evening. Region championships, you know, we talked about the fact, Cody, just so identical in so many ways, and this is going to be one that you and I both expect to go right down possibly to the wire.
No doubt about it, Jeff. And this is, I think, one key about this game. While every coach loves to take it in steps, they want to get to a region title, then you go on to taking it game by game in the playoffs. But I think one of the biggest things is gaining home field advantage in the playoffs. That can be huge and pay big dividends for your football team once you get into postseason play. And that's one big thing about this game tonight, is you want to ensure you have home field advantage once those playoffs begin.
Yeah. Absolutely, and there you see the lineup as far as top to bottom in Class 4A Region 6. Again, the two teams that we will see here tonight, Saxon, Cleburne County leading the pack, Cherokee County, Jacksonville still in there, and then it's a bit of a drop-off with Hokes Bluff, Sardis, White Plains, and Crossville still looking for their first win of the year. But again, even if you lose this game tonight, and obviously someone's going to lose it, you still kind of feel like they will be locked in at that number two spot.
You're right, Jeff. And there you see Jacksonville and Hokes Bluff. Big game tonight between those two. That's for that fourth place spot in the region. And that's a game to watch the score of. And Sachs, you know they've got to, they're looking for a little bit of revenge after last year losing to Cleburne County.
So that's Class 4A, Region 6. And now you see, and yep, that's a lot of information right there, and that is really the playoff scenario for all the teams in this area, from their class and region, their region records, all of that imported, of course, if you want to get to play an 11th game. You see Alexandria, we've already talked about the Valley Cubs, and A win tonight gives them a region championship. And all of this information that you see right now is available on our website. You can go to that at any time and just get you a high school football update, Cody.
A lot of great teams on here as we're seeing some of the teams we've covered so far in 2015. And that's a great thing about Week 8. You know, everything is taking shape, and we're getting ready for the postseason in high school football.
Yeah, just getting down to the old nitty-gritty right now tonight, and especially next week, we could just about start doing some bracket setting as far as the first round of postseason play in all seven classifications. All right, let's take another break, and we will be back with more from Jack Stewart Field as our pregame activities continue on the Friday Night Network.
Tonight's FNN High School Football Game of the Week.
This FNN High School Football Sports Exclusive
and by
Samco Express
Sonny King Ford.
FNN High School Football is sponsored by Calhoun
Quintard Avenue in Anniston,
where a handshake still matters.
Bank of Alabama.
And by Samco Express Parts.
And by Avery Auto
Sales. With over 30 locations in the area,
there's always one close by.
Your love will bloom with the Romance Bridal Collection. Each ring is a mirror to the natural splendor of sparkling diamonds with exquisitely crafted 18-karat gold designs. Every Romance piece is exceptional in both quality and style and comes with a lifetime guarantee that assures its everlasting beauty. Come see Phyllis and the team at Glencoe Jewelry Sales for the Romance Bridal Collection and all of your jewelry needs.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
It's not true. You cannot be in business and sell your product and not make any profit and stay in business. For that matter, if you did that, how could you take care of your customers in the long run if you never made any profit? We make profit, but the difference is we're fair with our customers. We don't mislead them, we don't misguide them. So come on down to the sunny side of the street and ask for me, Shane Denny. It's where a handshake still matters.
Step into the offices of J. Britt Middlebrook, CPA, where you'll find professional one-on-one service for business and individual clients. In this ever-changing tax and economic climate, you can count on receiving the expert advice you need. J. Britt Middlebrook works hard to provide every client what they need to meet all deadlines. Tax season will be here soon. For all your accounting service needs, call or stop by at 1913 Berry Street in Oxford. That's J. Britt Middlebrook, CPA.
And welcome back to Jack Stewart Field. Once again, top of the hour kickoff of Sachs and Cleburne County here this evening for the region championship in Region 6 of the 4A classification. Week number 8 of the 2015 campaign, the top 10 across the state of Alabama, according to the Alabama Sports Writers Association poll this week in Class 7A. Again, Bob Jones is there, Spain Park, who had the big upset over Hoover. However, Hoover's climbed to number 4, see Central of Phoenix City. And Theodore Murphy, Buckhorn, McGill, Tulin, and Prattville. You know, in the state of Alabama tonight, there are only two games involving top 10 teams. We've got one of them right here tonight. It's number 4, Sachs, against number 10, Cleburne County. The other one there, you saw it in Class 7A, and that was McGill Tulin playing Murphy this evening. The only two games being played across the state tonight involving top 10 teams. Class 6A, Clay Chalkville still there. Spanish Fort, still there. Opelika, still there. A lot of still theres, Cody.
A lot unchanged, excuse me, at the top half of the top 10 in Class 6A. Clay Chalkville, a solid football team, but as of right now, I believe Opelika might be the best team in Class 6A. They have been strong this year. They're playing great on both sides of the football, and they've upset a Central Phoenix City team at their house. So there's a lot of great teams in Class 6A.
Certainly is. Benjamin Russell there at number six, just one loss. McAdory, the Yellow Jackets, Park Crossing, Blount, and Gardendale rounding out the top 10 there in 6A. In 5A, Jackson Steele from down south Alabama. Jackson Steele, the number one team in the 5A classification. Gunnersville at undefeated at number three. Between Jackson and Gunnersville, you see St. Paul's, Greenville, Beauregard, a team we saw earlier in the year. They're at number five, rounding up the top 10. Mortimer Jordan, who, won a close one last week over Lincoln and still there in the top 10.
As you said, tough week for Mortimer Jordan, but they pulled the win out at Lincoln.
Class 4A, UMS Wright, still leading the pack. Leeds just keeps getting better and better each week at number three this week in the 4A classification. There you see Sachs, the team that we will see tonight, hosting Cleburne County at number four. Again, Sachs' only loss was to Welburn, opening game of the year. Andalusia, Priceville, Brooks, Cleburne County there at number 10. The Tigers of Coach Michael Short. Moving on to 3A, you see Madison Academy. They seem to be there every week. Well, they seem to be there every year, don't they, Cody? Pike County coming in with one first-place vote at number three. Piedmont, a team we saw, and they just seem to keep getting better and better.
As you said, Piedmont coming on strong in the second half of the year. There you see Glencoe, another top 10 team. Lauderdale County had a strong showing against Madison Academy last week. Madison Academy forced some late turnovers to win that football game. And as of last week, I didn't check the scores from last week, but as of last week going into week seven, Pike County had yet to surrender a single point in 2015.
Yeah, Pike County from down in Brundage, Alabama. Class 2A is Elba. Again, a lot of teams from down south. Have you noticed that, Cody? Of course, Tanner is from up north, up near Athens, but still Elba, the number one ranked team in the 2A division. You see Fife also from up north, Randolph County. We talked about them earlier. Looks as though that the Tigers of Randolph County may be headed toward an undefeated season.
Tanner might be the best team in Class 2A, the team to beat this year. There's some familiar teams. You see a Fife, the defending state champions. That's a team to watch out for. A lot of people might have written them off once they lost some key starters. But Fife, a team we always know Coach Benefield will have them going deep in the playoffs and potentially to Tuscaloosa this year for the Super 7.
And moving on to 1A, the smallest classification in Alabama, Maplesville, Cedar Bluff, Hackleburg, the top three. See Wadley down there at number nine with just one loss. So there you have the top 10 in all seven classifications. Third member of the FNN team is Caroline Saunders. And let's go downstairs and join Caroline right now.
Hey, guys. Starting Sachs running back Calvin Figueroa was getting both of his ankles taped during warmups. I had a chance to ask him what was going on, and he said he tweaked his heel a little bit, but not to worry because he's going to push through the pain tonight. He also told me he's feeling good about tonight and that he's confident in the Sachs team and very confident in his offensive line. Jim, back to you.
Thanks very much, Caroline. It's Sachs and Cleburne County for the Class 4A Region 6 Championship.
This FNN High School Football Sports Exclusive is presented by Sonny King Ford. Here yesterday, here tomorrow, on Quintard Avenue in Anniston, where a handshake still matters. And by Samco Express Marts. With over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Tonight's game is sponsored by Calhoun Insurance. For all your auto, home, business, or life insurance needs, visit us in Jacksonville, Anniston, or Gadsden. By Cycle World Power Sports on Megan Boulevard in Gadsden. At Cycle World, we sell fun. By First Bank of Alabama. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. At First Bank of Alabama, we're still first, and so are you. By Food Outlet, with locations in Alexandria, Anniston, Bynum, and Pell City. At Food Outlet, you always get great service and low prices. It's how we do business. And by Avery Auto Sales on Highway 78 in Oxford, and now open with a second great location on Quintard Avenue in Anniston. Tonight's Game of the Week is brought to you by Anniston EMS, Wesley's Paint and Body, Cotton State Barns, K.L. Brown Memory Chapel, Glencoe Jewelry Sales, Cable One, and Skinner Body Shop. We'll have more pregame activities when we continue. You're watching the FNN High School Football Game of the Week on the Friday Night Network.
The captains are at midfield. Let's join the head official, Jimmy Buckaloo, for the coin toss.
Okay. I have a coin that has a flag on it. The flag, the other side is tails. What is your choice?
Tails.
Tails? If I drop it, we'll do it again. Call tails.
Tails.
And it's heads. You've won the toss. You want to defer.
Yes, sir.
Red has won, and they will defer.
Sacks has won the top.
You want the ball. You want to defend the scoreboard. Red puts you back to the scoreboard. White, face the scoreboard. Cleburne County will receive. Okay, right here, shake hands, guys. Let's go. Have a good ball game.
So there you have it. As Sacks will be receiving. No, I'm sorry. Here I am. Cleburne County will be receiving to get this football game underway. We'll take one more break. We're back. It's opening kickoff time on the Friday Night Network.
At Food Outlet, our lineup starts with the freshest produce in town.
When you shop with us, you score every day with the freshest meat and the best selection.
Pre-game, halftime, even after the game, we have all the snacks and soft drinks that you need.
We're your hometown team.
And you'll always score a touchdown at Food Outlet, where great service at low prices is how we do business.
Food Outlet, with locations in Alexandria, Anniston, Bynum, and Pell City. Go to shopfoodoutlet.com for weekly specials. And remember to like us on Facebook.
And welcome back as the Wildcats have made their way onto the field and the crowd continues to file in. But, you know, it was an early arriving crowd also. I mean, I got here, I don't know, a little after 5 o'clock, and you could look at the Cleburne County faithful across the way. And, boy, they made the drive over from Heflin early this afternoon, Cody.
They did, Jeff. I got here around 5 o'clock on the dot, and the stadium was a little bit empty. But as you said, right a little after 5, this place started filling up. As you can see, the headlights here about 20 minutes ago, they were lined up out to the highway. This is a huge game, and both of these fan bases know it.
This is the 37th meeting between these two schools. Cleburne County leads the all-time series 20-16 in victories. A year ago, Cleburne County defeated Sacks 34-20. The first meeting all time was back in 1965. It's the 50th anniversary, I guess you could say. 50 years ago, these two teams played for the very first time. Sacks won that game 25-6. The coaches for Sacks, Buster Douthat. For Cleburne County, Wayne Cahee. Again, Sacks will be kicking off to Cleburne County to get this football game underway. The Wildcats in their home uniforms here this evening on Senior Night 2015 at good old SHS. Glad to have you along, and we expect a good one, folks. Just strap on the old seatbelt and hold on here. The Wildcats and Cleburne County on the Friday Night Network. The kick is away. The kick is picked up at the 21-yard line and returning now up the center of the field with a hole across the 30, still on his feet at the 40, down the near boundary and across the 45 up to the 47-yard line. That's a 29-yard return, and that was Noah Ware, and that will give Cleburne County great field position to start this football game.
Number 6, Travarius Cottingham for Sacks with the tackle. And if you're Cleburne County, you love your starting field position on your opening drive here in this football game.
First and 10 for Cleburne County. They'll start from their own 48. On the first down call and thrown for a loss back near the 44-yard line. Henson, the ball carrier, that's Jason Henson. And boy, he was hit immediately. And that will be negative yardage on first down for the Tigers as they will lose 4.
Great penetration by number 75, Mario Thomas for Sacks. And number 52, DeMario Burnett. And that was huge for this Sacks defense. as they stuff that play to begin on their first play of this football game.
Brock Swofford is the quarterback for Coach Michael Short's Cleburne County Tigers. As they come to the line of scrimmage, they will have three wideouts to the near side. It's second down and 14. That's Henson in motion, and Swofford wants to throw under a heavy rush. Pass is incomplete. Pass was intended for his wide receiver, Jacob Lee, but just a bit too tall for Lee. Incomplete, and in a hurry, Cleburne County facing a third and very long.
Great penetration and blitz there by Demetrius Powell, number two, the middle linebacker for Sachs. He does a great job pressuring Brock Swofford to make a high throw. It was a bad throw off his back foot. And here it forces a third and long situation. Sachs' defense has come on strong. Let's see what Cleburne County can do here to try to answer and get this first down.
Third down, 14. The line to make is the Sachs 42. Running room. First down and more down the near boundary. Across the 30, 25, down near the 20-yard line. The ball carrier once again was Jason Henson for the Tigers. Kind of expected him to go to the air, Cody, but they run the football to the near side, and Henson off to the races.
And there you see Henson show a burst of speed on the counter as he takes it back to the short side of the field, and a huge gain for the Cleburne County offense. And here we go. We see them set up on about the 22-yard line.
That's a 35-yard run by Henson on a third and 14. On first and 10, Henson gets a yard this time, and that's all to the 20. It will be second down and 9.
And tonight, what you'll notice out of Cleburne County, they're going to line up in a lot of tight end sets on offense. They're also going to run a lot of the counters. That's what we saw just now for the big game for Cleburne County. Let's see how Sachs can adjust and try to slow down this Cleburne County attack. As we've talked about before, both of these teams very good when it comes to the offense.
Mario Thomas made the tackle from his defensive tackle position. On second down and 9, running room, not at all. No gain on the play. The first time tonight that Easton Clark has run the football for Cleburne County, and it's for nothing. No gain on the play. And again, Cleburne County will be facing a third down and long.
Third and long situation for Cleburne County. I don't believe what's not going to work tonight for this Cleburne County offense is running right at the teeth of this front seven for Sachs. They're going to have to get out there to the edges and try to use speed to get these first downs.
Third down and 9. Swofford, you see there, not a lot of folks like to wear jersey number 13, but he does. And again, they need the 11-yard line. Swofford to throw. Throws deep downfield. Incomplete. Got a penalty marker down. Contact was made down near the goal line. The intended receiver was Jeremiah Blake. They call him Hot Sauce. Incomplete, however, a big third down penalty upcoming.
And that was a huge penalty made by the Sachs Wildcats defense. As Hot Sauce Blake would have had that one in the end zone. It was a bit high, but I think if he wouldn't have been impeded a little bit in his route there, he would have caught that one for a touchdown. He's a returning starter, and Blake might be one of the best players we've seen all year. Very athletic guy.
Let's get the call downstairs.
During the pass interference on the defense. Go. Right down.
Let's see if Cleburne County can put 6 on the board here.
Second down goal at the 9. On the second down play, Cleburne County has trips to the wide side of the field, which is to the top of your screen. Second down. Swofford rolls to the wide side, throws into the end zone. The ball had it for a moment, but he was hit hard and the ball popped loose, almost coming away with a catch. Again, that was Henson, but he was hit, unable to hold on to it. It's an incomplete pass.
Great hit by number 8, Landon Peters, as we see Swafford drop back. He throws the pass. What would have been a touchdown, and there you see number 8, Landon Peters, just lowers the shoulder and knocks that football free. That was a great play by the safety for Sacks.
8:39, the clock is stopped on the incomplete pass. In this drive, Cleburne County has converted twice on third and long, once on a long run, and the second time was due to a defensive penalty. Here they are facing third and goal at the 8. Pass into the end zone. It's too tall back in the corner of the end zone. It was intended for Jeremiah Blake. Really double, I guess you could say triple coverage over there for Sacks. Fourth down at the 9-yard line, and Cleburne County will look for 3.
It looked as though that was number 4, Quinn Smith, and number 44, Ashton Scotting, double coverage in the back corner of the end zone. And there you see Swafford try to toss the ball up in the back corner of the end zone to Jeremiah Blake.
This will be a 26-yard field goal try. The kick is up, and the kick is good by Hunter Carlisle. And Cleburne County is on the board. 8:29 to go, opening quarter. The Tigers lead the Wildcats 3-0 on the Friday Night Network.
Have you got the new car itch but don't want to take the plunge with a brand new car? How about getting the most car for the money at Avery Auto Sales? They have a large selection of cars with even some 2014s in the mix. And if you're worried about your credit, don't. They can help get you back on your credit feet with guaranteed approval. Check them out online at AveryAutoSales.net. Then when you see something you like, call them at 256-835-8897 for a test drive. Or just go by. Avery Auto Sales is located on Highway 78 East between Highway 78 and Snow Street in Oxford. That's Avery Auto Sales.
Opening drive of the football game, nets 3 for the visitors from Heflin, Alabama, as a 26-yard field goal is up and good by Hunter Carlisle. 3-0 now Cleburne County as they prepare to kick 2 sacks. And any points on your opening drive is always big in a game like this, Cody.
You're right, Jeff. You have to be pleased that you put points on the board. If you're sacks, you got to like how you settled in and you didn't allow 6 there. You only kept them to a field goal.
Carlisle's kick is away. It's a short one. It's picked up at the 15. Returned over the 20 up near the 25-yard line. That's just a 10-yard return. However, it will give Sacks a first and 10 now near their 26-yard line. That's Rodney Reddick on the return for the Wildcats. And now we will see this offense of Sacks that's put a lot of points on the board here in 2015.
And Cleburne County with a lot of returning starters on defense. Jeremiah Blake plays cornerback as well as wide receiver. And we see Justin Harder, number 5. He's a returning starter at middle linebacker. Number 44, Wade Dassinger. He's a linebacker as well, returning starter. And number 20, Chad Brown. He's a rover. He plays both strong side and weak side outside linebacker.
Quinn Smith is the quarterback, and they'll run the football to the near side, cutting back and getting out of the pack. My goodness. One of the best runs I've seen in quite some time, and it nets about 7 yards on the play.
A great run there by number 2, Demetrius Powell. He's your wide receiver, and he does a great job taking that one upfield. Should have been a loss, but he gains about 4 or 5 yards.
From the 35-yard line, they'll run the football near the first down, still on his feet, and finally taken down. Well, that's 2 pretty impressive runs on just 2 offensive plays by Sacks as they get near the first down, and they do indeed move the chains as it is a first and 10 now for the home team.
And there you see on the read option, quarterback Quinn Smith, number 4 for Sacks, with a nice athletic play. He thought he was stuffed for a second, but he gains his composure and gets a first down for Sacks.
And this is Figueroa getting the carry, his carry, the first time of his number is called tonight, and the senior moves up near the 40-yard line. That's a pickup of maybe 3 yards on the play as John Robinson comes in to make the stop.
And number 22, Calvin Figueroa, he's already over 1,000 yards for the season. He's a big bruiser. And tonight we're going to see him potentially get a lot of carries as they try to wear down this Cleburne County defense.
Second down and 7. Figueroa again. And 3 yards again. It will be third down and 4 for Sacks at the 43-yard line. Christian Hartley there defensively for Cleburne County.
As I talked to one of the assistant coaches for Sacks, Coach Bedwell, he just kind of told me that what they like about Quinn Smith, their starting quarterback, he makes good decisions. He has that scrambling ability, so when things break down, he can get outside with his feet and make some plays on the fly. And one thing that's going to come in handy tonight, they believe, against this Cleburne County defense is his ability to run and throw.
Third down and four. Pass caught. First down. A whole lot more. He may go. He's going to go. He's going to go. Touchdown, Sacks, on a third down and four. A 57-yard touchdown pass from Quinn Smith to his wide receiver, Demetrius Powell. From about the last 30, 35 yards, Cody, it was a race to the end zone, and it's a race that Powell won.
And if you're Coach Michael Easley, the offensive coordinator for this Sacks Wildcat team, you have to love that big explosive play. Here we see the read option play action. He tosses the ball out to Demetrius Powell, who takes it to the house. Look at this burst of speed as he just outruns all the defenders and takes it to the house. And Demetrius Powell, the type of guy that this team will feed off of. He is one of the key leaders on this Sacks Wildcat team, and that was huge for their first opening drive.
Point after is up and good, and with 6:25 to go in the first period, Sacks leading Cleburne County 7-3 on the Friday Night Network.
Whenever some little bug found its way into Miss Crenshaw's home, well, everyone with an earshot knew it. Now, it just so happened our son studied and collected insects, and so he took great joy in coming to her rescue. And I'll have you know, this marked the beginning of what one day would become the most successful pest control company in the area. Pick up the phone and call the professionals at Rice Pest Control, and you'll be glad you did.
And welcome back, Cleburne County and Sacks, from Jack Stewart Field here this evening. Jeff Ellison alongside Cody Spoon, Caroline Saunders. Each team has had one possession. The difference, Cleburne County got three, Sacks got seven, Cody.
And a great response by Sacks. If you're Coach Jonathan Miller, you have to love how your team responded. They gave up 3 points, but they go right down the field and score on a huge play from Quinn Smith to Demetrius Powell. And I think those are two guys we're going to call their name a lot here tonight.
The Nails kick is in the air, another short kick, and it stays in bounds. And they had to pick it up right on the near boundary. It's kind of the way the first kick was aimed or headed toward the sideline, but it was picked up and returned. But a short turn, however, by Noah Ware this time, had a 29-yard return on his opening kickoff, but this time instead he stopped at the 29-yard line. First down for Cleburne County.
We'll see if Cleburne County goes back to that counter to the short side of the field to see if they can use that speed. They've not had any success really running directly at the front seven for Sacks. They've had some success in the passing game. Let's see how they mix it up on this drive and see if Coach Short can get his offense moving.
First down at the 29. Swafford will keep it himself, but he stopped for no gain. Again, open field tackle there was Will Fletcher in to make the stop for the Wildcats. Second down 10 for Cleburne County.
Great open field tackle by number 37, Will Fletcher. That's one thing. It's kind of a lost art now in football. Those open field tackles, you see a lot of people just kind of throw their arms at people. That was great breakdown and tackle by Will Fletcher.
Second down 10 for the Tigers. Swafford to throw. Under pressure, he will run. And he will slide down at the 32-yard line. It's just a pickup of three. Third down 7 now for Cleburne County.
And there you see big number 75, Mario Thomas, with a ton of pressure on Swafford as he is forced to roll out of the pocket and get what he can. He rushes for about a 3 or 4 yard gain. It brings up a third and long situation for Cleburne County deep in their own territory. Let's see if they can convert here.
They need the 39 on this third down play from the 32. Swafford to throw, does throw, pass caught near the first down marker, and he got a good spot. I think he may have it too. On the receiving end of that toss was Jacob Lee. And from our vantage point and from where they placed the football down, and you can hear the Sacks faithful, they did not like the spot because it will indeed give Cleburne County a new set of downs.
Very generous spot by the officials on that play. Nonetheless, Cleburne County with a fresh set of downs. here in their second drive of the football game.
We'll call it the 39-yard line. You see the score, Sacks leading by four. They'll run the football inside, short gain, however, up near the 43-yard line. This will be a pickup of maybe 4 yards on the play. Will be second down and six. Again, Henson gets the call for Cleburne County.
And on that last play for Cleburne County on offense, you see the two tight end set. They got an A back and B back on either side of the quarterback, and just a simple handoff as they gain about 3 yards.
Second down at the 43. Running the football, getting back to the line of scrimmage, maybe the pursuit of Sacks quickly in there, and this will be about a yard loss on the play. Back to the 42, and yet again, Cleburne County facing a third down and long.
Again, we see Will Fletcher flying all around the football as he slows down the running back, number four for Cleburne County. That's Easton Clark, and then number five for Sacks, Rodney Reddick, comes in to finish the play off. And again, a third and long situation.
Swafford to throw. He does throw. Pass is thrown a bit behind him. Had to reach back for it and unable to corral it. The intended receiver again was Dunston. Falls incomplete. And this, their second possession of the night, will result in the punting unit coming on the field for the Tigers.
And if you're the co-DC for Sacks, Coach Wes Ginn, you got to love what your defense did there. They applied a lot of pressure to Swafford to make him, force him to make bad throws. And there it was, well behind number 28, Nick Dunston.
Kick is away, lands at the 35, and they'll blow it dead at the 31-yard line. So it will be Sacks football from their own 31-yard line with a first and 10, leading by four at 7-3. Really a good start for both teams here tonight. And I think, you know, maybe both teams are kind of settling down now.
I agree, Jeff. And if you're Sacks right now, you're building off of the momentum of that touchdown. Your defense gets a stop, forces the turnover, and you get the punt there, and you down it. You got it about the 30. You're on 31-yard line. And let's see what Sacks can do here moving this football, or see if Cleburne County can respond on defense.
From the 31. Smith will give to Figueroa with a hole. Figueroa fights up near the first down marker. Give him 9 yards on the play. Coach Miller will take that all night. 9 yards on the first down. Second down and one upcoming now for the Wildcats.
As you said, if you're Coach Miller and you're Coach Easley, the offensive coordinator, you got to love what you see out of your running back. As I alluded to, number 22, Calvin Figueroa, is over 1,000 yards this year. He's a pounding bruiser back, and here we see him up in the open field.
My goodness, the offensive line is really doing the job up front, and all Mr. Figueroa's got to do is run. I don't think anyone touched him until he got near midfield. That's a chain mover, first and 10 Sacks now at the Cleburne County 44.
And this is something Sacks likes to do. They like to go no huddle at times, speed things up, and get some defenses out of position on offense.
This is rapid fire offense here for Sacks, and it is paying off. Calling his own number that time is Quinn Smith, the quarterback. And Smith takes it for 5 yards, make it 6 yards, down to the 38.
And I had the pleasure of meeting this Sacks staff last year at the Super 7 down in Auburn. And one thing that they talked about was kind of beginning to implement some of this hurry up, no huddle into what they do offensively in their identity. And it's worked so far this year for them.
And they'll run Powell to the near side. Look at that cutback inside the 30. That's first down and more to the 27-yard line. Another first down for Sacks. Taylor Rice made the tackle for Cleburne County, but another chain mover for the home team.
And there you see the wide receiver, Demetrius Powell. Like as I said, he's the guy that the coaches know that he's a leader, and this whole entire team feeds off of his energy and what he does on offense and defense.
Not much this time on first down. I say that, but still he gets 2, maybe 3 yards down near the 25-yard line. Under 2 minutes remaining in the opening quarter. Each team scoring on their initial drives of the football game. 7-3 now, Sacks leading. Sacks looking for more on this, their second drive, facing second down. We'll call it 8 from the Tiger 25-yard line. Snap back to Smith. He gives to Powell. Powell looks to bounce outside, nowhere to go. Looks to bounce inside, and nowhere to go. He's knocked down at the 25 for no gain.
That's going to be number 8, Matt Norton, for the Cleburne County defense, bringing down Powell. And he does a great job as that defense for Cleburne County used their speed, got out wide, and that's what Powell was trying to do, is get out as wide as he could and use his speed to break open in the open field, but no going as this Cleburne County defense didn't back down.
Third down and 7. Smith runs near side. Smith fights his way for a first down. He's got it. And down to the 14-yard line he goes, picks up 11 yards on third down and 7, and they'll move the chains again as they're now operating inside the red zone with a first and 10.
Great block, great block by number 3, Quay McCord, for sacks, the wide receiver, as he turns his man to the inside, allows Quinn Smith to shoot back inside and get the first down for the Sacks Wildcats.
At the 14, Figueroa the call. And look at Figueroa fight his way down near the 8-yard line for a pickup of 6 more. Second down and 4 now for Sacks inside the 10. This drive started at their own 31, looking to take it 69 yards on this, their second possession of the evening.
And just to clarify, Sacks is a no-huddle team, but at times they install that tempo, that up-tempo style, when they get back to the line of scrimmage. There you see they didn't huddle. They use a lot of signals and signs to get the play call in.
And look at that. I mean, does it get any easier? Again, you know, we've got to talk about that offensive line, Figueroa. I mean, all he had to do was run, Cody.
And now you see why he had over 1,000 yards rushing coming into this ball game. Sacks now has established themselves at the line of scrimmage. They're being more dominant on the offensive front and the defensive front. And if you ask any coach here on either side tonight, they're going to tell you that's where the football begins. That's how you win football games. And he is practically untouched as Figueroa goes into the end zone for the touchdown. Sacks so far in this ball game is dominating up front.
2 drives, 2 touchdowns, and 2 extra points. 23 seconds to go, first quarter. It's all Sacks early, leading Cleburne County 14-3 on the Friday Night Network.
We build things that work the way you wish they would. Like a front-end loader you can detach from your seat. Or a mower deck you just drive over and cut through knee-deep grass no problem. Yep, we thought the same thing you did. That's why we build them this way. That's how we run. Nothing runs like a deer.
14-3, you see the score. Let's go back downstairs and join once again the pride of Lakeland, Florida. Here's Caroline Saunders.
After that last sack touchdown, one of the defensive linemen came over to the offense and was giving them high fives and just saying, "That's right, that's how we do it." And guys, I have to say, I have never been around a team that encourages each other more than this Sacks team, from the coaches to the players. This is one close team. Guys, back to you.
Thanks very much, Caroline. Once again, Sacks kicks to Cleburne County. It's a short one again. Fielded at the 20 again. And it's still on his feet at the 35 and finally taken down at the 43-yard line. His third kick return already, and we're still in the first quarter. That's Noah Ware. Cleburne County will operate from their own 44.
It's something that Sacks will need to clean up in this football game is tackling and special teams, as we've seen all the first 3 returns by Cleburne County. There's been some poor tackling by Sacks. And to kind of go back to that last offensive drive, they've got 2 returning starters for Sacks on the offensive front, number 79, Logan Main, and number 58, Austin Hobbs. So they've got some returning veterans up front that can help lead that offensive line.
Running the football for Cleburne County, that's Jason Henson once more, and he takes it down to the 48-yard line. That's a pickup of 8 yards on the play, and that is the final play of the first quarter. So after 12 minutes from Jack Stewart Field, Sacks leading Cleburne County by 11 on the Friday Night Network.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Field.
Right now, all Ram trucks are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,700 on this 2015 Ram 1500 at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
Just my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And welcome back to Jack Stewart Field. Again, headed to the second quarter now as Cleburne County will have the football on Sac's side of the 50-yard line. And yes, it's early. As I said, we're just starting the second quarter, but you kind of get the feeling Cleburne County needs to get something going here, because if the first two possessions are any indication, this Sac's team is going to put a lot of points on the board tonight.
Coach Michael Short, his offense seems to have responded. I mean, even though it's one play on this drive, they get an 8-yard gain running the football. That's their second biggest game, I believe, in tonight running the football. And so this team has to respond. Cleburne County just has to settle down. They're still in this football game. They're only down by, 11 points. So they're still well in this football game. It's early. And Cleburne County, just settle down. Keep doing what you've been doing all year on offense. If you're Sacks, you've put together good football so far on offense and defense, as we'll see what Cleburne County dials up here at the beginning of the second quarter.
You see some of the scores from around the area tonight. Of course, just so many big games, and the playoff bracket soon to be decided, and all those games you see right there, just about all of them, not absolutely all, but so much on the line here this evening across the state of Alabama in all regions and all classifications. It's second down and one for Cleburne County from the 47-yard line of Sacks. 9 yards by Henson on that first down play. And on this second down play, it's a first down as they pick up about 3 on the play to move it down to the 44. First and 10.
It's going to be number 7, Trevor Houston, on the carry for Cleburne County as he gains the first down. And I believe that was going to be Kanan Mays, number 9 for Sacks, in on the tackle for the Wildcats defense. Huge first down pickup for Cleburne County as they stalled out on their last drive. So a good job by them getting their first down and keep this drive moving along.
First down for the Tigers. Wofford to throw, does throw, pass caught. First down and a whole lot more inside the 30. Hit hard over there near the 28-yard line, but still, that's a pickup of 15 yards, and they'll move the chains again. Just a rollout pass by Swafford, thrown well, and just great execution throughout.
Number 37, Will Fletcher for Sacks, almost had to tackle from behind, but a great block by Stashen Henson, number 10 for Cleburne County, as he throws the big block to spring his wide receiver forward.
First down, call it the 29. Henson takes it to the 25, running off right tackle. It's second down and 6 for Cleburne County. They'll put it down at the 25.
It looks as though Cleburne County needed to have that touchdown to kind of put a spark in them. It kind of woke them up, it looks like. And so their offense is putting some stuff together here, mixing it up quite well as they're moving the football right down the field on Sacks early in the second quarter.
That's Blake to the top of the screen on second and 6. Swafford rolls to the near side. He's under pressure and trouble, and he just throws it away. The nearest receiver to that pass was Chad Brown. It's now third down and 6 at the 25.
And you see number 2, Demetrius Powell. We've called his name a lot this year, or this game so far. And number 9, Kanan Mays, with the pressure on Swafford, and he just has to throw the football away, and it brings up a 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6 situation for this Cleburne County Tigers offense.
10:44 to go here in the first half. Play clock is at 10, and again, Cleburne County continues to look to Coach Michael Short and his coaching staff. They may need a timeout. They do. Play clock was about to run out. So timeout on the field. You see Jonathan Miller, head coach, now in his 4th year here at Sacks. We'll step aside, take a break on the Friday Night Network.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes or if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Arnell Insurance in Oxford is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
This quarter of tonight's game on FNN is brought to you by iCare Alabama, with convenient locations in Piedmont, Heflin, and Roanoke. For more details on iCare Alabama, visit their website at alabamaeyecare.com. iCare Alabama, efficient, effective eye care close to home.
It's third down for Cleburne County at the 25, and they'll run the football outside and being stopped short of the first down, I do believe. He kind of fought his way up near the marker. That was Easton Clark, but he will be taken down near the 21, call it the 22-yard line, and fourth down for Cleburne County. And Cody, I don't think they'll hesitate at all right here. They'll go for it.
I think this is one of those points in the ball game you got to go for it. The position you are on the field, and there are not a lot of great kickers in high school football in this area, so this is one of those situations where you got to go for it on fourth down.
They need the 19 and a half from the 22. Quick pass. It's batted into the air and caught, but still short of the first down. Off the ricochet, I think maybe an offensive lineman came away with that one, but still he was taken down at the 20, and the ball goes over on downs.
What looked to be a first down play, a first down throw by Swofford, ends up, I believe you're right, it just deflected off the receiver, and one of these linemen caught it and tried to get the first down, but he's about a half a yard short, and Sachs will take over on its own 20, about 21 and a half yard line to begin this drive. Here we see the pass. It just bounces off the helmet of number 5, Rodney Reddick, for Sachs. And that was probably one of the crazier plays we've seen so far in this season.
So Cleburne County comes up empty on the drive. It goes back to Sachs, and that's Figueroa for just a yard, taken out at the 21 to bring up second down and 9.
And there you see number 44, Wade Dassinger. He's a returning starter at linebacker for Cleburne County as he drives Figueroa out of bounds after about a yard gain. And one thing about this Cleburne County defense, they're using a lot of speed to get outside. They don't want to get beat out wide by this Sachs Wildcats offense.
From the 21, second down, Figueroa. How many times have we seen that here in the first half? I mean, just running between the tackles. He just about say he's running between the guards. Picks up 8 more right there.
And he's doing a great job running the football tonight so far, just power running, and give credit to his offensive line. They've gotten a great push for him and opened up some big holes for him to run through.
Third and about a yard and a half, penalty marker down, and we may have an illegal substitution. I think Cleburne County may have been caught with 12 players on the field, but we'll get the call in just a moment from, again, the white hat, and the white hat tonight's Jimmy Buckaloo.
We have a 5-yard illegal substitution foul on White, results in a first down.
So a 5-yard penalty there, and again, that's an easy way to acquire a first down, Cody. I know Coach Michael Short does not like to see that.
You've got to cut out mistakes like that in a huge game like this, and Sachs is definitely going to try to take advantage of that 5 yards.
First down, Smith to throw, does throw. Wide open receiver on the near boundary and is finally taken out of bounds. On the receiving end's Josh Murray for Sachs, but not before Murray takes it to the Cleburne County 49, and they'll move the chains again.
Number 34, Noah Ware, the cornerback for this Cleburne County defense, comes up to try to make a tackle and drive him out of bounds. He successfully kind of gets him off balance and knocks him out of bounds, but Murray just kind of ran over him.
Smith keeps it himself, and he'll turn the corner and pick up about 6 more down to the 43-yard line. This seems like every play is positive yardage for Sachs, and they just continue to put pressure on the defense of Cleburne County. Nearing the 9-minute mark, an 11-point lead for Sachs. They'll give it to Figueroa. Not much this time, however. Stopped short of the first down at the 40. It's third down and 1 for the Wildcats.
And it's this situation, you got to believe they're going back to Figueroa. He's a guy that hasn't really been stopped tonight for, or hasn't really gotten a negative gain so far tonight. If he's getting anything, he's getting at least a yard out of it. So you give him the football here. He's a powerful runner. We've seen it do it time and time again tonight. You're winning up front. Let's see what they do here.
Third down and one. And they do just what you said, and there he goes. He was hit at the line of scrimmage, Figueroa. However, he bounced off that would-be tackler and takes it 19 yards down to the 21, and they'll advance the chains once again.
Big third and short run by Figueroa, and here you see Sachs using that that tempo, because there you see he's hitting the backfield by number 77, Bobby Lee Funderburk for Cleburne County.
And back to live action, they run Figueroa again. He gets four down to the 17-yard line. Again, just running inside, just continuing to pound it in there, and Figueroa nets four more. And Figueroa nets five more. Make it six more to the 11-yard line, and they'll move the chains, I do believe. Another first down for Sachs. Well, a touchdown here, Cody, and this game is far from over, but Sachs is really playing with a lot of confidence, and they could go up by 18 possibly if they're able to move it 11 more yards on this Cleburne County defense. And they're kind of playing on their heels right now, and, I mean, I can certainly understand why.
You're right, Jeff. I mean, it's obvious right now that Sachs has a lot of momentum. They're taking advantage of that momentum, and they've moved this football right down the field on this Cleburne County defense. And if they put up six here, it's going to be hard for Cleburne County to fight back on the road.
Smith throws into the end zone. Got it. Touchdown. There was a collision there, but Powell was able to hold on to it as he crossed the goal line. And it's suddenly a 20-3 Sachs advantage as they move up by 17.
Great coverage by Cleburne County's secondary on that play, but Powell just overpowers. And let's see this throw here from Quinn Smith as he throws a dart in there. And number nine, Skyler Jarrell for Cleburne County with a huge hit on Powell. But Powell catches that football, brings it in, a strong catch, and puts another six on the board for Sachs.
And another extra point on the board as well. 7:17 to go before halftime. It's Cleburne County down 21-3 to Sachs on the Friday Night Network.
When you wanted fast, when you needed speed, we've always been the one. Well, now, the fastest just got faster. Introducing Ultra 100 Internet from Cable One. Experience speeds up to 100 megs. Welcome to Ultra 100 Internet.
Cable One, the fastest just got faster.
21-3, now the score. Cleburne County scored the first point of this football game, but 21 unanswered now by the Wildcats, and Sachs now in control of this football game. But again, you know, it's still a long way to go, and Cleburne County shown an ability to put points on the board throughout the season, Cody, no doubt about that. But the big concern right now for Cleburne County, I would think, is trying to find a way to stop this Sachs offense.
In Cleburne County, their defense has been stout all year, but tonight they're being attacked by the Sachs Wildcats offense. If you're Coach Miller, you've got to be pleased with what you've seen out of your football team here in the first half.
That's Ware on the return. That's Ware in the open field, and Ware gets across the 30 to the 31-yard line. That's a 22-yard return. And first down now for Cleburne County, down by 18.
Number 44, Ashton Scott on the tackle. And I think that's the only thing, if you're Coach Miller, that you're kind of upset with right now is your special teams coverage unit. They've had a lot of tackling issues covering these kickoffs. Let's see if they can get that cleaned up at halftime, or at least before halftime, and we'll see how this thing goes for them.
From the 31, running the football is Henson. He tries to reverse his feel, but he is tripped up at the 33. And that's just a pickup of two on the first down play.
Great tackle by number five, Rodney Reddick. It looked as though Jason Henson had cut it back and was going to find some open space and take this football up for a first down, but no going as number five, Rodney Reddick, makes a huge tackle.
Second down and 8. 6:32 to go here in the opening half. Play clock is at 5. Swafford to throw on second down. He'll air it out deep downfield. This pass is incomplete. Flat penalty marker down, however. That pass was intended for his wide receiver Henson down near the 35. And this will, in all likelihood, we'll get the call momentarily from Jimmy Buckelow, but this looks to be defensive pass interference.
Let's wait and see the call. Yes, it's going to be pass interference against Sachs. I believe that was number 8, Landon Peters, in coverage for the Wildcats defense.
That's a 15-yard step off. Moves it out near midfield. And there you see the pass intended for Henson.
Well, defensive pass interference. It's a 15-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
And they'll put it down at the 49 of Cleburne County. First down and 10. Pass interference, of course, in high school, it's not a spot foul. Beyond 15 yards downfield, they'll just bring it back to the line of scrimmage and step off 15, and that's what they did right there. In motion goes Trevor Houston on the first down play, and Houston's got the catch, and Houston's got maybe another first down as he takes it to the 40. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down once more for Cleburne County.
And on their last drive, Cleburne County did not have issues moving the football, but came up empty on a fourth down play. And here you see they're moving the football again. If you're Sachs' defense, you can't get too confident right now in this football game. You've got to keep playing strong. It's early in this game so far.
Trips to the near side. Henson will run it. He's in the open field. Another first down for Cleburne County. So again, the Tigers looking to answer back here, and they get back-to-back plays that netted 11 yards, and it moves the chains again. At the 29, first and 10, Cleburne County. 6-1 overall, 5-0 in region play. Only loss was to Coach Bill Smith and the Munford Lions back in week number 1, and that was a home game. That game was played at L.E. Bell Field. From the 29, first and 10. They'll run it again, and they get a whole lot more, and down to far boundary. Touchdown, Cleburne County from 29 yards out, taking it the distance is Easton Clark. It's a cliche, yeah, I know it, but gotta say it. That's what the doctor ordered right there for Cleburne County. A big drive, impressive drive to get back in this ball game.
Great blocking up front by this offensive line and downfield by these wide receivers as Easton Clark shows a burst of speed to get into the end zone. As there we see, he cuts it back inside. Great block there by number 50, Sam Pate, to seal off the edge. And you see Easton Clark just walk into the end zone.
And Carlisle's extra point is up and good. And with 5:37 to go here, still in the first half, a lot of points in this one and a lot more to come, I'm sure. 21-10, Sachs leading on the Friday Night Network.
We're not trying to hide behind anything. We're trying to be honest. And if you go on our website and look at our, say you pick out an F-150, not only will it show you what we will actually sell that vehicle for, it'll show you what the rebates are, what the rebates are for. It'll let you go ahead and submit your credit to buy that vehicle. If a dealer is not willing to put the price of their vehicle on the internet, say call for price or something like that, is that really a dealer you want to do business with?
21-10, it's Sachs now up by 11. Let's quickly go back downstairs and join Caroline.
Hey guys, the Sachs offensive line coach feels confident in his offensive line controlling the rest of the game. He said he'll keep running right at them until Cleburne County finds a way to stop them. Guys, back to you.
And we have really seen that in the first half, just running, as she said, right at them. Kick fielded at the 14, returned by Sachs, but not very far. That's Powell, and they'll take him down at the 23-yard line. You can look across the way, and a little momentum I think, is in the possession of Cleburne County right now. Just a little more excitement on that Tiger sideline.
And just as sure as it seemed like all the momentum was in the hands of the Wildcats, the Tigers answer back. And they've got a little more pep in their step than we've seen as of late out of this Tiger defense. You can see them coming out. They look a little more confident. The sideline, the players over there, they looked as though they've kind of settled down a little bit. They're ready to go. And let's see what this Cleburne County Tiger defense can do to kind of help them, the help the entire team out and get their offense the football back.
From the 22, their own 22, first down, 4 sacks. Figueroa has 3, but he stood up at the 25-yard line. Second down and 7 yards to go upcoming now as Matt Norton made the tackle for the Tiger defense. Second down at the 25. Again, Sacks in their hurry-up mode. Snap back to Smith. Smith again gives to Figueroa. He fights his way near the first down marker. He will be, I think, just a bit short at the 31. He will be short, third down and 1.
And yet another run right up the middle by Figueroa, third and short situation. You know he's getting the football again.
And he gets it again. Oh, my goodness, the defense of Cleburne County. They needed that on a third down and 1. I think everybody at Jack Stewart Field knew that Figueroa would get the call, and that includes the 11 white jerseys on the defense of Cleburne County. And they take Figueroa down for a loss back at the 29. And for the first time tonight, Sacks will be forced to punt.
That's the first negative play we've seen, negative running play. But number 22, Figueroa, and there you see big number 40, Mario Smith for Cleburne County, shoots the gap, makes the play in the backfield.
Punt formation for Sacks, a line drive kick that will land at the 35-yard line and roll inside the 25 down to the 23-yard line. That's a 48-yard punt thanks to the roll, and a first down now for Cleburne County at their own 23. They needed a 3-and-out by their defense, and they got it.
And if you're Coach Short, you're very happy with how your team has responded. They could have easily kind of lost a little bit, given up maybe just a tad bit going down like they did. But they answer on offense. Their defense comes back out there. They put together something equally as impressive, and your offense has the ball back here on about the 23-yard line and moving.
First down, Cleburne County down by 11. They'll run near side and not going very far, are they? They will lose yardage on the first down play as being thrown down for a loss. Again, that was Jason Henson back at the 20. Second down, 13 for the Tigers.
Number 28, Andrew Kilgore, looked as though he was going to get the tackle, but he wasn't quite fast enough. And there you see number 8, Landon Peters, come up to make the tackle in the backfield for about a 3 or 4 yard loss for Cleburne County.
Second down, 13. Swofford to throw, does throw, pass is caught. Good yardage on the play. Oh, my goodness. Kind of a WWE move over there as he is taken down up near the 33-yard line. That will be near the first down, however.
I thought there for a second we were about to see a pile driver on the field. As he went high up in the air, I think he was above their helmets. It's a third and about half a yard situation. And a good job holding on to the football there by Cleburne County. That could have easily been a turnover. Here we see rolls out. Swofford rolls out, dumps it off to number 28, Nick Dunston. And that's number 44, Ashton Scott on the tackle.
And on third down and less than a yard, Cleburne County runs the football, and they run it for a first down as they pick up 9 yards on the play from the 33 all the way out to the 42-yard line. And Cleburne County keeping this drive alive on that third down conversion. Clock slowly becoming a factor here with 2.5 minutes to go. Cleburne County does have 2 of its 3 timeouts remaining. Still running the football and still running the football with success. Trevor Houston takes it down near another first down to the 48.
And this ball game is about to get interesting as it looks as though Cleburne County has decided they want to dominate the line of scrimmage. They're doing a good job defensively and now offensively, as we've seen on back-to-back drives. They're getting big pushes up front. And their running backs, when they get the handoff, they're already about 3 yards down the field. So big gains for this Cleburne County offense as they have become much more physical up front.
This will require a measurement. They'll stretch it out. Got the first down. First down, Cleburne County at the 48-yard line. Boy, if they could punch one in here, these two teams could go into the locker room. And early on here in the second quarter, it was all sacks in control, up 21-3. But Cleburne County with an opportunity here to score back-to-back touchdowns and make this what we expected, a ball game. They'll run the football, but losing yardage on the first down play. Clark goes down back at the 49. It's a loss of one.
That was a busted play as it looked as though Clark wanted to try to cut it back inside, but number two, Demetrius Powell, the middle linebacker for this Sachs Wildcat defense, comes up to make the stop in the backfield. About a yard loss, bringing up a second and 11 situation for the Cleburne County offense.
Still plenty of time on the play clock. It's at 14, at 13. Second down and long at the 49. Swofford gives to Henson. Henson is pushed out of bounds at the 45-yard line. It's a pickup of four. And it's third down and seven for Cleburne County. It's pushed out of bounds, and that stops the clock with 1:32 to go before the bands take the field.
And great awareness by number 21, Jason Henson, as he gets out of bounds, as he was met around the out-of-bounds boundary of the line. But he steps out of bounds and stops his clock where they don't have to burn one of their timeouts.
Third down, seven. They need the 38. Swofford to throw, has time, airing it out deep downfield, makes out there, incomplete, and another penalty marker down. Again, Blake, the intended receiver, and from our vantage point, I think there was early contact.
And I believe it's going to be against number eight, Landon Peters again. He was, here we see Swofford drop back, and they're going to call it on number eight, Landon Peters. He was the one that committed the pass interference on the last drive that ultimately led to the Cleburne County touchdown. Let's see if this thing comes back to bite Sachs.
That was a third and seven call, and again, that will be a defensive pass interference. We'll get the call right now on the mark.
Pass interference on the defense. Toss in the first down.
So a penalty, and Cleburne County will turn a third and seven into a first and 10 at the Sachs 30-yard line. Swofford to throw on first down, pumps once. Now he rolls near side, looks, and just throws it out of bounds.
Great pressure by number 52, DeMario Burnett, for Sachs. And if you're Coach Short, that's something on third down you can dial up, just that lob pass up there. And it looks as though this offensive staff realizes something that they can capitalize on, and they're doing a good job of it right now as they're just lobbing that pass up there whenever Landon Peters is in coverage, and they've gotten him back-to-back times on the pass interference play on third down.
Incomplete pass stops the clock with 1:17 to go. Again, two timeouts at their disposal for Cleburne County on this drive. From the 30, second and 10. Swofford, this one deep downfield. Receivers out there, goes high into the air. Did he come down with it? He came down with it. Touchdown, Cleburne County. That's Blake over there in the corner of the end zone and showing his leaping ability, and it results in six.
And there we see Hot Sauce go up high and make that catch, brings it down in double coverage as he had a defender all over his back. And that was just a strong showing by him to catch that football and bring it down as we see Swofford drops back and just lobs this one up for his wide receiver to make a play on the football. And here we see he tracks it down, uses his athletic ability. He just jumps up there. Might have got away with a little bit of a push off on number 44, Ashton Scott, but nonetheless, that's a touchdown for Cleburne County and one they needed.
21-16, and the point after a bad snap from center. They were unable to put it on the tee, so no good on the extra point. So the score holds. Sachs 21, Cleburne County now 16 on the Friday Night Network.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama, we're still first, and so are you.
...21-16. Some plays deserve a second look. Some deserve a third look, Cody.
And here we'll see the replay. Swofford just drops back, as we said. He pump fakes, then he just lobs the football up there for Hot Sauce to make a play on it. As you see Blake get up at his highest point, catches the football, and comes down in the end zone. And that was a nice touchdown grab by Blake.
21-16, and while we were away, just a squib kick down the field by Cleburne County, and Sachs falls on it near the 30-yard line, and it will be first down and 10 now for Sachs at their own 30. Now, Sachs, as far as their final possession before halftime, they got 107 to go, and all three of their timeouts. Michael Short, head coach of Cleburne County, now in his 18th year, and of course, he's a graduate of Cleburne County High School as well. From the 20, call it the 27-yard line, first and 10. Figueroa into the open field yet again. And this will be 12 yards from the 27 all the way out to the 39. They'll stop the clock and move the chains.
And here's where installing tempo and practicing tempo and having that a part of your offensive playbook comes in to effect. And it's an advantage that you have. And here we see the Wildcats go to work.
Clock is under 50 seconds. Smith takes and gives to Powell. Powell bounces it outside and takes it to the 47-yard line. Again, Sachs has all three of their timeouts, and they use one of those three right now. 40 seconds to go here before halftime. Timeout by Sachs, leading 21-16 over Cleburne County on the Friday Night Network.
Hi, I'm Curtis Skinner. Trust me, to win out here, you have to have a team of experienced professionals behind you.
The same kind of professionals you'll need after an automobile accident. And that's what you'll find at Skinner's Body Shop in Oxford.
At Skinner Body Shop, you always get free estimates, and our dad's crew can fix it like new. Everybody's seen Bull around with our rollback ready to handle all your towing needs. We work with all major insurance carriers. So, the next time you
need... All right, enough of the details. Just come see my dad at Skinner Body Shop.
Sachs using one of its three timeouts. And again, 40 ticks remaining here in the second period. When play resumes, it will be Sachs facing a second down and three from their own 46-yard line. And what was at one time an 18-point Sachs advantage is an 18-point advantage no more. The lead is down to five. Second down and three. Smith takes, Smith runs. Short of the first down, he goes at the 48-yard line. Upcoming will be third down and one. There to make the stop was Wade Dassinger for Cleburne County. And I think they are going to just take it to the locker room. They do not use any of their timeouts. They run the football, and that will be a first down run by Figueroa. They'll stop the clock just to move the chains, and once they do reset them, the clock will restart. So they may not run another play, and from the way you see it there, Sachs is walking toward the sideline. Did they use one of their timeouts? Apparently they did. So they do use the second timeout. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back. Stay with us on the Friday Night Network.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations: Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College. Central to you. Central to your success.
All right, here we go. One, maybe two more plays. I think there's all that's left here in the opening half. And Smith wants to throw. Now he wants to run, and he's hit at the 48-yard line. That looked to be a quarterback draw, but Mario Smith says, uh-uh, I'll take you down right here. And that will end the first half. So 37 points put on the scoreboard here in the opening half, 21-16. I think that, yes, Caroline is caught up with Coach Jonathan Miller down on the sideline. We'll maybe see if we can get with Caroline.
Coach, Cleburne County is not what you want to see going into the second half.
On top 21-16 as teams make their way to their respective locker rooms. Quite a first half, and we'll be back with halftime activities. You're watching FNN. Well, first you see some of the highlights of the first half, and it was highlights galore, Cody.
You're right, Jeff, and here we see the long touchdown run by number 4, Easton Clark. And there's the semi-pile driver that we saw earlier. And here's the huge catch by Blake, and that was just a nice catch.
Halftime, Sachs leads by 5. Halftime activities headed your way on the Friday Night Network.
Hey, you got one of those insurance apps too? You know how this thing works?
No, sorry. Not an app, it's my agent.
In this moment.
No, I'm fine, thanks.
It's good to know you have a trusted, independent auto owner's insurance agent who's there when you need them.
Great. Man, I gotta get one of those.
Auto Owner's Insurance, the no problem people.
Calhoun Insurance in Oxford is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
This is a nice place. How much do you think this is going to cost us?
I have no idea. Surely they'll show us some options.
I wonder if we should have asked.
At K.L. Brown Memory Chapel, we believe creating a service to match your budget is the best service we can offer.
I thought for sure it was going to cost more.
I'm so glad we can afford what we want.
Whenever some little bug found its way into Miss Crenshaw's home, well, everyone with an earshot knew it. Now, it just so happened our son studied and collected insects, and so he took great joy in coming to her rescue. And I'll have you know, this marked the beginning of what one day would become the most successful pest control company in the area. Pick up the phone and call the professionals at Rice Pest Control, and you'll be glad you did.
Need a place to keep your tools?
Or a place to get away from the wife? Whatever your needs are, we got a barn or a carport for you.
With rent-to-own options and no credit checks, we can help you take home the right barn or carport today.
And with 4 different locations, we're just a short drive away.
So come see us in Glen Cove, Moody, Asheville, or Atala, and let our family help your family get the barn or carport you deserve.
We build things that work the way you wish they would. Like a front-end loader you can detach from your seat. Or a mower deck you just drive over and cut through knee-deep grass no problem. Yep, we thought the same thing you did. That's why we build them this way. That's how we run. Nothing runs like a deer.
Welcome back to Jack Stewart Field. The first half, Cleburne County scored the first 3 points of the game, and then Cleburne County scored the final 13 points of the first half. However, in between there, Sachs scored 21, and that is the score here as Sachs leads by 5. Quickly down to the field, let's enjoy the Cleburne County High School Tiger marching band.
Thank you.
2015. The band director, Doug Baker, the Cleburne County High School marching band halftime. It's Sacks on top of Cleburne County 21-16. Back with more on the Friday Night Network.
Well, it's a bad tactic. What happens is customers get these mailers and they're told that they win $2,000 for showing up at the dealership or $20,000, and when they get there, it's never the case. It's just simply to get them in there and pull their credit and see if they can buy a car, and it's really dishonest. It's a bad way of doing business, and we're just not going to do that. So come on down to the sunny side of the street and ask for me, Shane Denny. It's where a handshake still matters.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
Now what?
Let's go. That way.
Have fun out there on the compact, capable, and entirely new Pioneer 500 from Honda.
Visit Cycle World in Gadsden today or online at cycleworldonline.com.
Your love will bloom with the Romance Bridal Collection. Each ring is a mirror to the natural splendor of sparkling diamonds with exquisitely crafted 18-karat gold designs. Every Romance piece is exceptional in both quality and style and comes with a lifetime guarantee that assures its everlasting beauty. Come see Phyllis and the team at Glencoe Jewelry Sales for the Romance Bridal Collection and all of your jewelry needs.
And welcome back. You see the score, 21-16, Sacks on top of Cleburne County after 24 minutes of high school football. And, of course, got an interesting second half coming up, I'm sure. Let's go back to the field and enjoy the Sacks High School marching band. We'll be right back. the Sachs High School marching band here at halftime. Once again, a five-point lead for Sachs over Cleburne County on senior night here 2015. We'll be back with more on the Friday Night Network.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all GMC Sierras are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,900 on this 2015 GMC Sierra at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
When you wanted fast, when you needed speed, we've always been the one. Well, now, the fastest just got faster. Introducing Ultra 100 Internet from Cable One. Experience speeds up to 100 megs. Welcome to Ultra 100 Internet.
Cable One, the fastest just got faster.
For over 15 years, Advantage Tire has been the go-to place for all your wheel and tire needs. They carry all the top brands as well as do alignments, brake service, and even custom wheels. Advantage also provides exhaust work as well as windshields and wiper blades. Be sure to visit the friendly staff at 5750 Highway 202 in Anniston so you can get your car back on the road in no time. Call Advantage Tire at 256-792-3390.
At Food Outlet, our lineup starts with the freshest produce in town.
When you shop with us, you score every day with the freshest meat and the best selection.
Pre-game, halftime, even after the game, we have all the snacks and soft drinks that you need.
We're your hometown team.
And you'll always score a touchdown at Food Outlet, where great service at low prices is how we do business.
Food Outlet, with locations in Alexandria, Anniston, Bynum, and Pell City. Go to shopfoodoutlet.com for weekly specials. And remember to like us on Facebook.
It's the game of the week on the Friday Night Network. You see the score as we're slowly winding things down here at halftime, 21-16. Again, Cleburne County scoring first in this game. They got a field goal to go up top early, 3-0. But Sachs coming back with 21 unanswered to go up 21-3. And then closing out the first half, it was Cleburne County on back-to-back possession, scoring touchdowns to make an 18-point lead, just a 5-point advantage here at halftime, and really what we expected, right, Cody? I mean, yeah, Sachs jumped out early in the first half, but Cleburne County coming back there late.
And yeah, Jeff, I mean, this is it was impressive for me to see, you know, Sachs comes out and does a great job initially. I mean, they had all the momentum. They were dominating up front. Next thing you know, Cleburne County just decides they want to play football. As I said, in the middle of the first half, it was almost like Cleburne County needed that, you know, that smack in the mouth to be down that far just to spark them and give them some momentum on their sideline. So they did a great job adjusting, getting things going there in the second quarter. And we look for this second half to live up to the hype of this football game.
You see the scores running across the bottom of your screen right there. Many big games throughout the area. And I guess the biggest surprise right now in this area and right now as far as other games are concerned, and that is Weaver with a halftime lead over Glencoe.
And that's one thing, as we were talking about here in the break, I just didn't see that one. No disrespect to Coach Hamby and Weaver, but I felt like Glencoe would you know, take control of that game and lock up that second spot in the region. But the Bearcats not going down without a fight, and seems like we got a ball game on our hands there. That's huge for Region 6 in Class 3A.
Yes, it certainly is. You see Pell City down to Chelsea. That's a first-half score. Hanley, just one loss. We saw those guys earlier in the year with a big lead there as they head toward the break. Hoke's Bluff trailing Jacksonville. And, well, you see the scores right there. And, of course, our game right here, just a 5-point lead for Sachs. And, you know, I'm not saying they relaxed, because I know Coach Jonathan Miller would not allow his crew to do that. But when they did jump out to a 21-3 lead, I'm sure, you know, a lot of folks were thinking, hey, this game could be close to being over here in the first half. But that didn't happen at all, did it?
Coach Short got his guys to respond. I think that might be the most impressive thing that we saw is this game was almost just out of reach for the Tigers, and they come back and respond well, and they did well in all, on offense and defense. They did well, you know, beginning the game with their returns and their kickoff returns. They were getting big yardage, big gains on that, but their offense stalled out and their defense couldn't stop anything. But there you see them respond. They continued to return the ball very well on kickoffs, and they did a great job on defense stopping that run up the middle. I mean, they just stacked the box and forced sacks to continue to run the football. And even though, you know, the offensive line coach said he would keep running until they stopped it, well, they've stopped it. So now you got to make some adjustments going into the second half.
5-point lead again. Sacks on top of Cleburne County. Third quarter action is headed your way. Stay with us on FNN, the Friday Night Network.
Have you got the new car itch but don't want to take the plunge with a brand new car? How about getting the most car for the money at Avery Auto Sales? They have a large selection of cars with even some 2014s in the mix. And if you're worried about your credit, don't. They can help get you back on your credit feet with guaranteed approval. Check them out online at AveryAutoSales.net. Then when you see something you like, call them at 256-835-8897 for a test drive. Or just go by. Avery Auto Sales is located on Highway 78 East between Highway 78 and Snow Street in Oxford. That's Avery Auto Sales.
Whenever some little bug found its way into Miss Crenshaw's home, well, everyone with an earshot knew it. Now, it just so happened our son studied and collected insects, and so he took great joy in coming to her rescue. And I'll have you know, this marked the beginning of what one day would become the most successful pest control company in the area. Pick up the phone and call the professionals at Rice Pest Control, and you'll be glad you did.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
The final home game of the regular season for the Sacks Wildcats here this evening. Their final two regular season games are on the road. They'll travel to Jacksonville and then down to Chambers County, that is, to take on Lafayette in week number 10. You know, talking about region play, Cody, this, of course, is Class 4A Region 6. And since Jonathan Miller's taken over as head coach of Sacks, his record in region play is absolutely incredible. 26 games and he's 24-2. His only two losses in region play last year to Cleburne County. Then you got to go back to 2012, and that was when he suffered his only other loss in region play, and that was to Piedmont back in 2012. You go 24 out of 26 in the region, and you're going to get a whole lot done.
You're right, and there's one thing about this job. There's a ton of talent coming through here at Sacks, and he's doing a great job. Him and his staff are doing a great job staying consistent, building something special here at Sacks. And this is the type of job I could see him staying here for a little while just because of all the talent you've got. You've got constant talent coming through. Just as far as the second half, I feel like Demetrius Powell, number two for Sacks, needs the ball in his hands a lot more on offense. He's a guy that the coaching staff talked about being the leader, the guy that everyone looked to, the guy that everyone fed off of his energy and his momentum and the things he was doing. We saw him with that long touchdown scamper for a touchdown. So let's see if they get the ball in his hands a little bit more and see if he can't lead this offense here in the second half.
All right, here we go. Third quarter action. Region 6 championship on the line here at Jack Stewart Field. The opening kick sails out of bounds, and that will give Sacks the football at their own 35-yard line with a first and 10. You hear this week in, week out, in just about every game that you see, and whether it be from high school all the way to the guys that play on Sunday. But opening drive of the second half is so important.
You're right, Jeff. I mean, this is a drive right here for Sacks where they need to move the football and they need to put points on the board. I feel like the way your offense kind of stalled out a little bit there in the, at the end of the first half, you want to put something together here, put together a good drive, and put some points on the board.
Quinn Smith, the quarterback, again trips to the near side. Now Powell goes in motion to the far side of the field. First down from the 35, and they run Figueroa, but he doesn't run very far, does he? Knocked down at the line of scrimmage for no gain. Second down and 10 for Sacks.
Sacks wants to try to test that front seven for Cleburne County and get their offensive line, see if they can get a little bit better of a push. And no going there as Cleburne County stays stout.
Second down and 10. Again, three wideouts to the bottom of your screen. You see them there. As Smith calls his count. And he'll throw the football. He does. A completed pass to Powell, but short gain on the play. Not much at all. Just a couple of yards. I think that was Houston coming in to make the stop.
Great open field tackle there by number 7, Trevor Houston. He does a great job watching the football and getting out there and making the open field tackle. Is something we alluded to early. That's a kind of a lost art in football these days, and he does a great job bringing down Powell in the open field for the short gain.
Third down and 8 at the 37. Pass is nearly picked off. That was Ware, had his hands on it at the 47-yard line. That was a dangerous pass and almost resulted in an INT, but still, it's 3 and out, and Sacks will punt the football.
Ill-advised throw for Quinn Smith. He kind of rushed that throw, and he looked down the wide receiver. Great coverage by number 34, Noah Ware, as he almost had the pick. I think he looked upfield rather than bringing that pick in, and the potential pick in, and then Trevor Houston hits him in the hands but falls down.
Powell's kick is away. Short kick lands at the 35 and takes a bit of a Cleburne County roll back to the 40, and it will be Cleburne County football now. First down and 10 at their own 40-yard line, and the Tigers with a chance to take the lead in this game on this possession.
A huge win for Cleburne County as they stop the opening drive by Sacks. Sacks won the coin toss, but they elected to defer to the second half. So that big drive stalls out. Cleburne County gets the ball back on their own 40-yard line, and they go to work.
First down, they'll run Henson. Henson turns the corner. Henson has a first down. Across the 50 and down to the 49, that's a pickup of 11 yards on the play, and they'll move the chains.
That's the same play we saw them run in the first quarter, early in the first quarter, to get the huge gain on third and long. As you see a simple counter, number 21, Jason Henson, takes that one for about a 12-yard gain as Sacks gets the ball inside, or excuse me, Cleburne County gets the ball in Sacks territory.
First down at the 49. It's like the same play. Looks like the same results. 12, 13 yards this time. Henson takes it from the 49 down to the 36-yard line. Have they found something on that right side of the offensive line? They continue to run that way, and they continue to have success.
They didn't really attack it. After they had that huge gain, they never really went back to it, and it looks as though, as you said, Coach Short has found something. He and his staff have found something that they want to attack. They're doing a great job blocking out there and letting the running back spring open for big gains.
Now they run to the near side, but not as much success. Trevor Houston runs it, but down he goes for no gain.
And they tried to go to the wide side of the field and near side to us, and they tried to get him out there in space to see if he could make a play, and no go there as the Sacks defense responds well and gets him and stops him for a no gain.
Second down and 10 at the 35. They'll run him again. That's again running to the right side. And again, a good chunk of real estate on the second and 10 call by Houston. Just that right side of the offensive line, the bread and butter right now for Cleburne County. Just a bit short of the first down, third down, and less than a yard for the Tigers.
And it looks as though we're going to have an official measurement. Whitehead, Jimmy Buckaloo wants to take a second look at this. I believe it's going to be a first down for Cleburne County.
Quickly downstairs, let's join Caroline.
Coach Miller went into the half wanting his offense to keep the pedal to the metal offensively. He also wanted his team to just establish the line of scrimmage on defense. So we'll see here in the second half if Sacks made those improvements. Jeff, back to you.
All right, thanks, Caroline. Short of the first down, it will be third down less than a yard for Cleburne County. The ball resting just outside the 26-yard line. And again, Cleburne County just running the football and doing so with a lot of success. And really what we expected from both teams here tonight. And, well, we're seeing what we expected to see.
And if you're Coach Jonathan Miller, you just got to be concerned at how your team has kind of lost its physicality in this football game. Cleburne County is just coming right back and hitting you in the mouth. And Coach Miller and his Wildcats have yet to really respond to that. And here's it's clear at this point that Sacks has no momentum, and Cleburne County has taken all of that out of them. And they're looking to get this first down. This would be huge for them, and that sets them up almost inside the red zone here early in the third quarter.
Third down, you see it, less than a yard. Henson, first down yardage. Down inside the 25 to the 21-yard line. It's a chain mover. First and 10 now for Cleburne County.
Number 28, Andrew Kilgore in on the tackle for Sacks.
You see, next week, where will we be? We don't know yet, but you see the potential games for next week and the possible locations of FNN. You see, as a matter of fact, Moody at Lincoln's a Thursday night game as well. So we will be somewhere next Friday night, guarantee you. So just check our website this week and we'll let you know early in the week, as a matter of fact, where our location for week number 9 will be. Okay, prior to the first down snap, we've had a stoppage in play as Jimmy Buckaloo steps in to sort things out here. 9:06, the clock is stopped, third quarter from Jack Stewart Field. And now Coach Buckaloo, you see, walks to the far boundary and talks with Michael Short over there, the head coach of Cleburne County. Any idea what this is about, Cody?
I'm not for sure. The whole staff is kind of irate about something. I was looking up and down the line of scrimmage and trying to figure out what Coach Short is so upset about as he's talking to the white hat. He is still not going to let him come back on the field as he's letting Jimmy Buckaloo know what his biggest concern is right now.
I don't think they're talking about a good restaurant to eat after the game. Of course, Top of the River is not far from here. First down from the 21-yard line. There goes Henson, but down he goes. He is taken down at the line of scrimmage as forward progress will get him back to that point at the 21. It's second down and 10 now for Cleburne County.
Big tackle by number 52, DeMario Burnett. He's also the left tackle on offense. He's a defensive end on defense for Sacks. He's a transfer. This kid is 6'6". He's very athletic, and just yesterday South Alabama was on campus to do a visit with him, so he's a guy that's getting a lot of looks from some college teams.
Second down and 10, Houston. And down he goes for a short gain to the 19-yard line. It will be third down and 8, near the 8-minute mark here of the third quarter. Cleburne County looking to take the lead here as they move inside the red zone. This drive started at their own 40.
Good job by number 9, Caden Mays, for the Wildcats, shooting the gap, making a play as it was a short gain for Cleburne County. Brings up a third and long situation, third and 8. You got to wonder right now if they try to pick on Landon Peters, number 8, as they've just kind of lofted that ball up on third and long situations.
Here we go. Big play. Third down and 8. They need the 11-yard line. Pass is complete. Houston's got it. Slips down at the 16. That's just a 3-yard pickup. It will be fourth and 5 for Cleburne County from the near hash mark, 16-yard line.
And it looks as though Coach Short's going to kick the field goal. I don't know where I got punt from. But it looks as though he's going to kick the field goal here on about the 16-yard line.
So they'll put the tee down at the 22. So this will be a 32-yard field goal, a bit of an angle to the right. Hunter Carlisle in. He's one of one on the evening and 3-point tries from 32 yards away. Now the officials step in, and we've got a delay call. A violation of the play clock as the flag is thrown, and this will back Cleburne County up 5 yards and make this a 37-yard field goal try, and that's a big 5 yards right there, and Coach Short's not happy, and he may change his mind here, and he is. As a result of that 5-yard penalty, they bring the offense back onto the field, I guess a bit out of Carlisle's range from that distance.
And that was a huge mistake by the special teams unit for Cleburne County, as they had plenty of time when they got out onto the field. I'm not sure what happened there, but here we go. Coach Short has to, he's forced to call a timeout.
He does. Takes a timeout. 7:01 to go, third quarter. We'll take a quick break as well. Back with our fourth down play on the Friday Night Network.
It's not true. You cannot be in business and sell your product and not make any profit and stay in business. For that matter, if you did that, how could you take care of your customers in the long run if you never made any profit? We make profit, but the difference is we're fair with our customers. We don't mislead them. We don't misguide them. So come on down to the sunny side of the street and ask for me, Shane Denny. It's where a handshake still matters.
When play resumes, it will be fourth down and 10 for Cleburne County. The ball is at the 21-yard line of Sachs. Cleburne County down by 5. They brought in their field goal unit a moment ago, but prior to the snap for the field goal, they were flagged for a delay of game. They backed them up 5 yards, and now Coach Short on 4th and 10 is elected to put his offense back out there and go for it. They're on their feet at Jack Stewart Field. Again, Region 6 championship on the line here tonight. Big play here in this football game. They need the 11-yard line, and Swofford to throw. Downfield, pass caught inside the 5. He dropped it. He had it for a moment and dropped it. It's incomplete on the pass intended for Jacob Lee, and he was wide open, Cody.
And that was a great play by number 3, Quay McCord, in the end zone as he was wide open. And for Cleburne County, catches that one in the end zone, but Quay McCord knocks it away. Here we see Swofford drop back, tosses the pass to number 10, Stashen Henson. And number 3, Quay McCord, just gets in there and wrestles that football out for the incomplete pass. That was huge for the Sachs defense. Now your offense has to get something going.
So, unsuccessful on 4th down. Now Sachs 1st down. Smith to throw. Deep downfield. Ware intercepted at the 40-yard line. Ware on the return. 35, near side 30, 28-yard line. So on 1st down, for one of the few times tonight, Sachs goes to the air, and Smith throws the INT. We'll look at it again.
And here you see Quinn Smith drop back. He has Powell open, but he just underthrows the football. At number 34 for Cleburne County, that's going to be Noah Ware, comes in and makes the pick. And that was a huge turnover for Cleburne County. Quinn Smith with a little bit of not an ill-advised throw, but he needed to put a little bit more on that football to get it to Powell.
Now they'll run Henson on 1st down. Henson's inside the 25, the 22-1, the 21-yard line. Make it the 20. It's a 9-yard pickup. 2nd down and 1 upcoming for Cleburne County. Big turnover there. I mean, your defense stops Cleburne County on a 4th and 10. Your offense comes on the field, and the pick on the very first play, and Heflin with, or Cleburne County from Heflin, with a lot of life now. 2nd down and 1 near the 20-yard line. They'll run Houston. Houston stops short of the line of scrimmage. Back at the 22, it will bring up 3rd down, about 2 now for Cleburne County.
And there you see number 2, Demetrius Powell, and number 37, Fletcher, in on the tackle. That was big for this Wildcats defense. You're asking a lot out of this defense coached by Coach West again. And here, a 3rd and short situation. You got to think they would go. This is 4-down territory for Coach Short.
They run Hudson. He bounces it outside, and he'll be close to the 1st down. Did he get a good spot? I think he did. It'll depend on the spot, and from our vantage point, they're going to move the chains here, I do believe. They will. No need to measure. 1st down, and Cleburne County converts on the 3rd down play.
That's going to be, it looked as though that's number four. Quinn Smith comes in to make the tackle, but not quite in time as it's a first down for Cleburne County.
At the 19-yard line. Had no scoring here in the second half thus far, but Cleburne County threatening here near the 18-yard line. Henson at the 15. Henson down to the 12. It will be a gain of six, second down and four.
Number 28, Andrew Kilgore for sacks makes the tackle. Great job on the counter play. Great blocking by this Cleburne County offense. They're doing a great job getting these running backs in open space, allowing them to make plays using their vision and the quick feet. Some of these running backs can cut really well, especially on those counter plays. They're cutting back on a dime. They're doing a great job running the football.
Second down and four. Running the football once more and down near the first down marker. That's Easton Clark. Down to about the 8.5. It will be third down and one, less than one actually, for the Tigers.
And with the personnel they have in the game right now, you got to believe this football is going to number four. It looks as though they're just going to line up under center and try to get this short yard.
They don't need much. About a foot is all. Third down from near the 8-yard line. And Swofford does go down under center. Quarterback sneak. Safest play in football. That's what a lot of coaches say. And it's a successful sneak by Swofford down near the 7. It will be first and goal for Cleburne County.
Swofford just laid on the back of his offensive line, and he probably got 3 yards out of that just by rolling off the top of those guys. And there you see is first down for Cleburne County. They're inside. They're about the 6-yard line moving forward here in the third quarter.
First and goal. Not much this time. Maybe to the 5-yard line goes Clark. It will be second down and goal at the 5.
That's going to be number 56, Devontae Garrett, on the tackle for the Wildcats. He comes up from the bottom of that pile. You got to think he had that penetration to get in there to slow this running back down. And let's see if Sachs's defense can stand tall here. You know Coach Ginn's asking a lot out of them so far because they turned the football over, but let's see what they can do here.
Second down, they run Henson, and Coach Ginn will like that. Henson is taken down back at the 6. It's a loss of 1. It will be third down and goal for Cleburne County.
Number 75, Mario Thomas, with great penetration on the defensive front. He's that big tackle down there. You can see from here how big he is. Just imagine how big he is on the field as he gets shoots the gap between the guard and the center, makes a play in the backfield, brings up a third and long situation. It's about a third. About third and 7, third and goal, about 7-yard line. Let's see if what Cleburne County does. This is clearly a big play for them.
And they better hurry up. The play clock is at 3, 2, 1, and Coach Short wants a timeout. They were about to be whistled and flagged for a delay of game, and quickly Coach Short steps in and uses a timeout. 2:30 to go, third quarter. We'll be back on the Friday Night Network.
Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all GMC Sierras are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,900 on this 2015 GMC Sierra at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
Was Sachs 21, Cleburne County 16. We've played 9.5 minutes of football here in the third quarter, and the score is still the same. When play resumes, third down and goal for Cleburne County at the Sachs 7-yard line. Coach Short just elected to use his second timeout of the second half. That may turn out to be big here, as the Tigers have just one timeout left here in the second half of this one. Swofford to throw on third down, does throw, pass is caught for the touchdown. Touchdown, Cleburne County. Noah Ware on the receiving end. At one time, they trailed 21-3 in this ball game, but Cleburne County has come all the way back and now lead by one.
And here we see Swafford drop back. Running back comes out of the backfield, number 34. It's going to be Noah Ware.
That was a heck of a catch.
That was a really good catch, and you thought there for a second, number 4, Quinn Smith, for sacks, stripped that ball out of there, but he didn't, and a good job, as you said, good catch and good run by Noah Ware into the end zone, and Cleburne County has come storming back. They're going for two here.
To go up by three, possibly, if they are successful on the two-point try. Swafford rolls, throws, pass is intercepted. You cannot return that, not in high school football, but it goes as an unsuccessful two-point try. However, Cleburne County now back on top, 22-21 on the Friday Night Network.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama. We're still first, and so are you.
And welcome back, Jeff Ellison. To my right is Cody Spoon, and down there on the field is Caroline Saunders, FNN's coverage of our game of the week, Region 6 championship game here this evening in the 4A classification. And what a game we've witnessed here as Cleburne County has made a heck of a comeback in this one, Cody.
If you're just now joining us, as Jeff said, this is a huge comeback by Cleburne County. The momentum has swung on their side completely. Oh, it's an onside kick.
Carlisle short kick, and Sachs is able to fall on it near the 36-yard line. There to fall on it was Josh Murray for Sachs. And now the Wildcats with a first down.
Looked like they wanted to skip that one over the heads of the front line, try to catch it on a hop. Get back on offense, but good job by Sachs falling on that football. And here they go. They're at their own 36-yard line. They need to get some offense going for sure here on this drive.
Smith hands to Figueroa, and there is some offense. Figueroa off right tackle, picks up 11 yards all the way to the 47. That will move the chains. It's been a while since a Sachs offense has really mounted anything offensively, but they look at the scoreboard now and find themselves down by one. First time they trail since early in the opening quarter. Figueroa again. 5 more yards this time to the 48.
And Figueroa with back-to-back powerful runs. As you see there, he should have been brought down around the line of scrimmage as he fights forward for about a 5-yard gain. It brings up a 2nd and 5 situation. You like how physical this offensive line for Sachs is after they've kind of been they've been whipped here so far by this Cleburne County defensive line here in the second half.
Funderburk made the tackle. Slow snap. Smith goes back, picks it up, and he's surrounded by white jerseys. It was like, here comes the cavalry. And they take Smith down back at the 40-yard line. That will be a big loss on the play of about 12.
Bad snap between his legs as it rolls behind him. He turns around, picks the ball up. He was looking to make a play. As here we see, he goes between his legs. Quinn Smith picks it up. And number 44 for Cleburne County, Wade Dassinger, the returning starter at linebacker, he gets the big sack there.
It's 3rd down and 18 now from the 40-yard line for Sachs. They need the 42 of Cleburne County to receive a new set of downs. Play clock's at 1. They get it off. Smith to throw. Screen pass caught by Figueroa, but down he goes immediately. Boy, they smelled that one out, didn't they? The defense of Cleburne County. No gain. 4th down, 18, and Sachs will punt it away.
Dassinger showing some maturity, the returning starter on your defense, one of many returning starters on your defense. As you see him, he read that all day long. He knew that was about to be the screen to the wide receiver as he drops Figueroa from, I think he maybe lost a yard. So brings up a fourth down situation. Sacks forced to punt the football yet again.
And Cleburne County has come close to blocking these kicks too. Low snap, Powell scoops it up. He nearly blocked that one, but he got it off. It's a short kick, but it takes a Sacks roll inside the 30 down to the 28-yard line. It will be first down for Cleburne County from their own 28, and that is the final play of the third quarter. We head to the fourth and final. It's a one-point Cleburne County lead on the Friday Night Network.
Oops, had a fender bender? Have them tow it or take it yourself to Wesley's Paint and Body. Baker Reynolds and his guys have been this area's go-to team for quality automotive body repair and paint work for years. All makes and models, foreign or domestic, they take them crashed and make them look like new. And with Wesley's larger new facility, including two full-size paint booths, they can get you fixed up fast. Always free estimates, best price on repair work, insurance claims welcomed, and service with a smile. That's Wesley's Paint and Body, Highway 78 East in Anniston.
Need a place to keep your tools?
Or a place to get away from the wife? Whatever your needs are, we got a barn or a carport for you.
With rent-to-own options and no credit checks, we can help you take home the right barn or carport today.
And with four different locations, we're just a short drive away.
So come see us in Glencove, Moody, Asheville, or Atala, and let our family help your family get the barn or carport you deserve.
In this moment, it doesn't matter if you save money in 15 minutes. Or if your neighbor has the same insurance that you do. What matters right now is the quality of your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Arnell Insurance in Oxford is your local independent auto owners insurance agency.
Here we go, fourth quarter action from Jack Stewart Field. It's Cleburne County football from their own 27-yard line. The Tigers with a one-point lead, and on first down, they get a one-yard run to the 28 by Henson. Will be second down and 9 now for Cleburne County. Final quarter, this again for the Region 6 Championship in Class 4A. Kind of the game we expected, kind of the game. And now into the open field is Henson, and there he goes all the way down to the 40-yard line. That will be a pickup of 32 yards on the play and a chain mover. And I tell you, momentum, and you can just see the bounce and the pep in your in their step, Cody. And another big run there by Henson.
Great job blocking by this offensive line for Cleburne County. They did a great job opening up a hole. I think you could have driven a tank through there if you needed to. And number 21, Jason Henson, shows the burst of speed, gets this ball up for a huge gain for Cleburne County.
First down at the 40. Henson again, and 7 more yards this time from the 40 down to the 33-yard line. It was Demario Burnett there to make the tackle for Sacks, but not before Henson gained 7.
And some of these holes that are opening up, give credit to these running backs. They're finding some holes to their backside, and they're using their vision to cut back and get through those holes. They're doing a great job using their vision on some of these runs. And as I said, this offensive line for Cleburne County right now is just whipping this front for Sacks. This is pretty incredible to see the kind of the holes that they're opening, the push that they're getting.
Cleburne County has scored 19 unanswered in this football game, and they run the football yet again with Trevor Houston, and Houston fights his way down to the 30-yard line, short of the first down, third down and short, however, third down and 1.
And it has gotten very quiet over here on this Sacks, in the Sacks stands. It's Cleburne County looks as though they're just building and building and building off of this momentum that they have built up. And we see Mr. Buckley wants to do a official measurement.
Yeah, they will bring in the chains. The clock has stopped now with 10:09 to go in the football game. And if you're just joining us, well, where have you been? You've missed quite a contest here tonight in Calhoun County, 22-21. At one time, Sacks led this game 21-3. And the second quarter, you see they stretch it out there, and he's just a tad short of the first down to bring up third down in less than a yard. But again, Sacks led 21-3 in this game. But since then, it's been all Cleburne County as they've scored 3 touchdowns, scored the last 19 points of this football game. And They're on the move once more. Third down, less than a yard now at the Sacks 30-yard line. They ran a quarterback sneak in this situation earlier, and again, Swofford will go down under center. He doesn't go down under center often, but he does here, and you expect a quarterback sneak. And there it is. And he didn't get the push he got last time, and, well, this is going to be close.
It's going to depend on the spot, and I say this is very close. I don't know that he quite got there. That was a great push by Sacks.
And it will be. No need to measure this time. Fourth down. Swofford failed to gain on third down. So it's fourth down and about a foot for Cleburne County.
You see they did a personnel change. They put in some bigger guys. Did Cleburne County up front.
And they'll run the football. Didn't make it. No, sir. Hit in the backfield, and it goes over on downs. And hats off to the Wildcat defense. They come up big right there.
Big DeMario Burnett just burst through this offensive line. I don't know that he was even touched. Watch him come from the backside, and he makes this play. Yeah, he just blew right through the offensive line for Cleburne County, and he makes that play in the backfield. That was huge for this Wildcats defense. And if you're Coach Wes Ginn, you got to love what you just saw to your defense. Yeah, they gave up a lot of yards, but they came through on third and short and a fourth and short situation, and you give the ball back to your offense. Coach Easley wants this Wildcat offense to get going.
They'll start this drive at the 33, and they'll hand it to Figueroa for three to the 36-yard line. And Funderburk again there to make the stop. It will be second down 7. We got an injury timeout, but he jumps to his feet in a hurry, so this injury timeout will not last long, will it? Second down and 7 now, 4 sacks. They've been shut out here in the second half thus far. And now with the football at their own 36. Smith to throw. Smith will run. Smith is still running. First down, Sacks to the 49-yard line.
And there you see Quinn Smith. He drops back the throw, feels the pressure, steps up into the pocket, and just sees a hole and decides to keep it himself. And he shows some great shiftiness there as he cuts back and forth and gets up and makes that first down for this Wildcat offense, as that's something they desperately needed, was a first down and keep a drive moving.
At the 49-yard line, the lone running back behind Smith is Figueroa. He hands to Figueroa. Figueroa has 2-3 to the 48. Second down and 7. Clock moves under 9 minutes remaining in the football game. Just a 1-point Cleburne County lead. Second down at the 47. Figueroa again, and he will be down back at the 48 for a loss of 1. Boy, both these defenses are playing so well in this football game, and now Cleburne County's resistance steps up and takes Figueroa down for a negative 1.
Number 5, Austin Harler, middle linebacker. He's another returning starter for this Cleburne County offense. He shoots through there and makes a play in the backfield, slows down Figueroa, allows another Tiger defender to come in and make the tackle. Brings up a third and long situation. Sacks needs to convert here.
They need 8 on third down. Smith rolls. Smith's not going to throw. He's going to run, and he does run, and he has the first down, and out of bounds he goes. Well, they say he stepped back at the 41-yard line. He may not have the first down. When you see the official where he's marked the football, it will definitely be close. They're indicating already fourth down, apparently, you see the down marker on the far boundary over there, fourth down. This is right in front of the Cleburne County bench. And yes, it's fourth down, 4 sacks. I would think they'll go for it here, Cody, I'm sure.
Where he stepped out of bounds, once he was hit, he was well past the marker, but the official over there saw it, and it's a fourth and short situation. And Sacks needs to convert this, desperately needs to convert this.
Here we go, fourth down. They will go, trying to draw Cleburne County offside, and I think they did. The official on the far side has thrown his flag, and someone has jumped into the neutral zone.
Great job using the hard count by Quinn Smith. He draws this Cleburne County front offsides, and it gives you a fresh set of downs. And it's a good job by a quarterback that his coaching staff says made good decisions. I realize he's had a couple of bad passes tonight, but that's a situation right there where you need a quarterback. Use that hard count, draw the defense offsides, and they give you your first down.
So, first down sacks now at the Cleburne County 36. 8:06 to go in the game, and they'll run Powell to the near side. Powell has five to the 31-yard line. There for the takedown defensively was Justin Harler. Second down, five now for sacks.
And there's great blocking on that play as Powell takes a sweep, comes back to the near side. He cuts it upfield. If there weren't for a couple of key blocks, that play would easily have been blown up in the backfield. But he gets about a 5 to 6 yard gain and brings up a second and five situation.
At the 31-yard line, they'll run Figueroa outside, and Figueroa cuts it inside and has a first down to the 25. That's a gain of six. And that will advance the chains once more for the Wildcats.
I love the patience on that run by Figueroa. He waits for his offensive line to get out there. It looked as though he was kind of wanting to go outside, but he sees a hole. He lowers that shoulder and powers through there, gets the first down for sacks, and they convert yet another first down.
At the 25-yard line, Figueroa again. 15, 10, 7-yard line. 18 more yards for Figueroa, and it's first and goal. Four sacks.
And Figueroa looks to be getting better and better on some of these very good drives that sacks has had so far. The more carries you give Figueroa, the more powerful and the better he gets. And let's see if they hand it to him again and try to punch this thing into the end zone.
First and goal. Smith will keep it himself. He now throws. Pass intercepted by Cleburne County at the five. He may go 95. He may go 95. This is hot sauce, Blake. He's going 95 yards for the touchdown. Oh, my goodness, what a turn of events here tonight at Jack Stewart Field. The defense of Cleburne County and Jeremiah Blake, the pick six for the Cleburne County.
And that was huge for Jeremiah Blake as Quinn Smith just makes a bad decision. He rolls out. He sees that he's not going to get any yardage, and he tries to throw it up there. And his receiver was well to the left side of that throw as Blake just steps in front of it, picks that ball off, and takes it to the house. There were no Wildcats anywhere near him.
28-21, penalty marker down on the conversion. The kick is up and good. We got a flag down. I think this may be against Sachs as they were running their 11th player into the lineup, and he got there late, and we'll get the call before we go to the break. But even with the made point after, it's still just a one-possession game. We'll let them sort it out here before we do go to this break, and we'll get the call from Jimmy Buckaloo. And the point is good, and they will penalize on the kickoff, I do believe, the offsides against Sachs. Well, it is declined, rather. So anyway, it's 29-21, and let's go back to what may be the play of the game, Cody.
Illegal substitution. Play action. Quinn rolls out. It looks as though it's supposed to be a quarterback keeper. And he had a receiver in the back of the end zone. Excuse me, I didn't see him, but he didn't put enough on the ball as he was just rolling out and had to throw that ball across his body. And he threw basically a duck. And Blake just picks that ball off and takes it to the house for a touchdown. As you said, that could be the play of the game. And that was huge for Cleburne County. As they, every time Sachs tries to get some momentum back, Cleburne County takes it right back out of them, keeps it all for themselves. And that was huge for Cleburne County. Big turnover, big pick six out of a guy that we've said was one of the best players for this Cleburne County Tigers team.
95-yard return on the INT. And the interception was a one-hander. He just reached up and just snatched it out of the sky there like he had a baseball mitt on or something. But what a play by Blake. Short kick now on the ensuing kickoff. And this will give Sachs great field position. And once again, it's just an eight-point lead. So it's still Sachs will start this drive just 55 yards away from possible tie.
with 6:50 left, some of the tempo things that they have in their offensive playbook, Sacks can easily put some points on this board. They just got to settle in. Quinn Smith needs to shake that off. He had a terrible throw there. It resulted in the pick six. He's got to shake it off. He's got to move forward with this game and try to put his team up on the scoreboard. Even if you have to kick the extra points, you're down by one. You got to think they'll go for two, depending on what kind of time they've got left. But there's still plenty of time to play in this ballgame. Anything can happen, as we've seen so far.
What a comeback by Cleburne County. They trailed it one time, 21-3, and Figueroa up the center of the field. Are they going to answer back? Figueroa to the 30, 20, 15, 10. Finally pushed out of bounds at the 7-yard line. At the 7-yard line, this is a 48-yard run by Figueroa, and just like that, Sacks is right back down there knocking on the door.
Huge hole to run through by Figueroa, and he shows a burst of speed. I haven't seen that speed out of him tonight. And that was a great job by Figueroa getting upfield and getting down. He fought his way to about the 7-yard line. He could have been knocked out around the 12, but he got about 5 more yards out of that run. I don't know why that was blown dead for a second, but nonetheless, Sacks with a big explosive play that they desperately needed.
Figueroa again, and Figueroa to the 2. 5 more yards, it will be 2nd down and goal at the 2-yard line. Now, this is the way you're supposed to play a region championship game.
Jeff, this is one exciting football game. This might be the best one we've seen so far here in 2015.
Low snap, Smith gives to Figueroa. Touchdown, Wildcats. It was all Figueroa on that possession. 3 carries, a total of 55 yards, and the Wildcats are just a 2-point conversion away from tying this game.
And I believe Coach Jonathan Miller just signaled for 1. I think he just wants to kick the extra point. I could be wrong here, but I believe he wants to kick the extra point.
Well, we're looking, and well, they're going to keep that offense out there, so they will go for 2 here for the tie. Snap to Smith. Give to Figueroa. Did he get in? We're tied. We are tied. He runs it in. 29 apiece. 6:16 to go in the football game. You're watching the game of the week on the Friday Night Network.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart. This quarter of tonight's Game of the Week is brought to you by L.E. Bell Construction Company in Heflin, a leader nationwide in pipeline and terminal construction, and proud supporters of the Cleburne County Tigers.
6:16 to go in the football game. Quickly down to Caroline with an injury update.
Guys, the Sacks quarterback came off to the sidelines after that touchdown, limping pretty bad. He is currently getting looked at by the trainer, so we'll continue to watch that. If he goes out tonight, guys, it could be really bad for this Sacks offense. Jeff, back to you.
All right, thanks, Caroline. The kick return down the far boundary, and Cleburne County will have the football near midfield as Henson takes it all the way back to the 50, now on the Sacks side of the 50-yard line near the 49, and now I guess it's Cleburne County's turn now to answer back. Tied at 29 with 6 minutes to go.
And that's not how you wanted to respond after the touchdown. If you're Sacks and your coverage team has just had issues all night tackling on kickoffs, and here we see Cleburne County starts out at the 50-yard line. Great field position.
First down and 10. They'll run the football inside for just a couple of yards and nothing more. That will be 2nd down and 8. That's Noah Ware, the ball carrier. 2nd down and 8 now for Cleburne County.
Great job by number 56, Devontae Garrett for Sacks, making the tackle as he just grabs on the jersey and yanks down the running back for Cleburne County.
2nd down 8 at the 48. This is Henson. Henson down near another 1st down. It'll depend on where they mark it. He will be a bit short. Just inside the 41-yard line, third down, less than a yard now for Cleburne County. Now, once again, early here in the third quarter, in the second half, Coach Michael Short used two of his three timeouts, so they only have one remaining. But as of right now, still over 5 minutes to go, and time is not a factor as Cleburne County faces third down just outside the Wildcat 40. They'll run the football, and Henson's got the first down. Down to the 35, that's a gain of six. They'll stop the clock and move the chains once more.
A couple of Wildcat defenders, they were more focused on trying to strip the football rather than making the tackle. And in that situation, you got to tackle and try to strip as you go down. And nonetheless, he gets the first down for Cleburne County, and they got a fresh set of downs inside Wildcat territory.
4:50 and counting, first down, 35-yard line. For Cleburne County, the Wildcat 35. Swafford will take, and they'll run again to the near side. This is Henson with four more. Oh, boy, what a collision right there. Give him maybe five. Forward progress to the 30. Second down and five. 4.5 minutes. Clock continuing to wind down. It's for all the marbles tonight. The Region 6 Championship of 4A, Cleburne County and Sachs from Jack Stewart Field, and everybody is on their feet.
As we're getting close to 4 minutes in this game, both of these teams know how big this is right here. Cleburne County's offense wanting to put some points on the board, and Sachs' defense wanting to come up with a huge stop here.
Second down, five at the 30. Snap back to Swafford. They'll run it outside. Now cutting it back inside up near the first down is Easton Clark. They'll put him down at the 26, third down and one for the Tigers. And really, you know, Cleburne County in no hurry at all right now, Cody, nor should they be. I mean, they just want to bleed the clock and maybe score in the final minute of this one. That would be just what that would be the game plan, I'm sure, right now.
Yet again, we see Easton Clark on the carry, that cutback. That's what's getting them these yards. They're going to, some of these plays, they would be blown up in the backfield, but they're cutting back and getting big gains.
Third down and one, inside they go, first down they go. Again, that's Trevor Houston, and he'll take it down to the 22-yard line, a gain of four. First and 10 at the 22. 3:23, they stop the clock to reset the chains, and now they restart it. Now, Sachs has all three of their timeouts at their disposal, and again, Cleburne County has just one. Play clock is at 15, and again, the Tigers in no hurry. Tie ball game, 29 apiece. Play clock is under five. Swafford takes the snap, gives to Houston. He bounces his outside, 20, 15, 10, 5. Did he get in? Touchdown, Cleburne County. Touchdown, Cleburne County. And 22 yards out, and the Tigers move back on top by six.
I believe we've got an injured Wildcat. That's going to be number two, Demetrius Powell. So you hope it's nothing serious. It looked as though he came in from behind to make the tackle and kind of got whipped around, maybe a shoulder. Don't want to really speculate, but hope he's okay. Because that was a huge touchdown for Cleburne County.
Yes, it was. Trevor Houston takes it in to give Cleburne County the six-point lead. They 2:53, just the way this game is going, 2:53 is a lifetime in this game. It will be upcoming, will be the point after. I tell you what we'll do during this official's timeout. We'll step aside and take a break. We'll be back to Jack Stewart Field. You're watching the Friday Night Network.
Whenever some little bug found its way into Miss Crenshaw's home, well, everyone with an earshot knew it. Now, it just so happened our son studied and collected insects, and so he took great joy in coming to her rescue. And I'll have you know, this marked the beginning of what one day would become the most successful pest control company in the area. Pick up the phone and call the professionals at Rice Pest Control, and you'll be glad you did.
We build things that work the way you wish they would. Like a front-end loader you can detach from your seat. Or a mower deck you just drive over and cut through knee-deep grass no problem. Yep, we thought the same thing you did, That's why we build them this way. That's how we run. Nothing runs like a deer.
All right, here we go with the point after. 35-29, Carlisle in for the extra point out of the hold of Harler. Snap, spot, kick, up. And the Cleburne County Tigers now lead by 7 at 36-29. We'll step aside on the Friday Night Network.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
The game of the week on the Friday Night Network. I'm Jeff Ellison. He is Cody Spooner and Spoon and Spooner. Okay. Cody Spoon, and she is Caroline Saunders. Sometimes I don't even know my name, Cody, so I apologize for that. I have no idea why I said Spooner. Don't even know any Spooners. We may need some spoons, all right? All right, the kick is out of bounds, and it will be out of bounds at the 39-yard line. First and 10 now for Sacks. Now, they have all three timeouts, and why do I get the feeling that we're going to see a lot of Figueroa right here?
There's no doubt. You can't go away from it. It's something that's worked for you all night, and he's been doing a great job, especially on that last drive. We saw him. He just had a nice big run that he had, and then a couple of power runs in for six. But, you know, passing the ball has been so-so tonight, so you don't really want to force this turnover here. That's ball game. So right now you want to take care of the football. Give the ball to Figueroa and make them stop you.
Now, this kick sailed out of bounds at the 38, so they will get the football from where the kick sailed out of bounds, since it was no deeper than the 35, if that makes sense to you. First down and 10 now at the 38. They get a yard up to the 39, and from there it's second down and 9. Clock winding down again. 2.5 minutes to go. Sacks needs a touchdown and a point after to tie this game and possibly send it into OT. From the 39, Smith calls his count. He'll take Figueroa will run the football. He almost dropped the football on the handoff, on the exchange from Smith to Figueroa. It was almost a big turnover there, but Figueroa was able to corral it, and still he only picks up a yard.
A third and long situation for the Wildcat offense. It's good to see number 2, Demetrius Powell, back in the game, as he was the injured Wildcat on the last score by Cleburne County.
Third down and 8 at the 40. They need the 48. Big play right here for Sacks. A minute 54 continuing to tick down. Smith to throw on third down. Does throw. Pass. Powell's got it. No, incomplete. He dropped it. Had it momentarily, but it falls to the turf. Incomplete. Fourth down now for Sacks. Fourth down and 8.
I think Powell had it, but as he was being brought down, he saw one of his players and he tried to toss it up, so he didn't really have possession of it. As it hits the ground, the official to our side signaled that it was down around the 9 yard, about a 9 yard gain. Here we see, Powell just lost it. He just lost it. He never really had possession of the football. I thought there for a second he might have flipped that one up to his teammate.
Here we go, fourth down for Sacks. They need the 48-yard line, and now Wildcats are forced to use one of their three timeouts. We'll take a quick break as well. Fourth down when we come back on the Friday Night Network.
At Food Outlet, our lineup starts with the freshest produce in town.
When you shop with us, you score every day with the freshest meat and the best selection.
Pre-game, halftime, even after the game, we have all the snacks and soft drinks that you need.
We're your hometown team.
And you'll always score a touchdown at Food Outlet, where great service at low prices is how we do business.
Food Outlet, with locations in Alexandria, Anniston, Bynum, and Pell City. Go to shopfoodoutlet.com for weekly specials. And remember to like us on Facebook.
All right, here we go. This possibly the old ball game right here. Fourth down, 8 sacks at their own 40. They need the 48, or it goes over on downs. Smith to throw on fourth down. Under a lot of pressure, he's going to run it. He will run it for the first down. First down, Wildcats. They needed 8, and he got 11 to the 49. Quickly downfield, we got another injury update with Caroline.
Hey, guys, I spoke to the sacks trainer after Demetrius Powell went down pretty hard in the last defensive series. The trainer said he just got the wind knocked out of him and he will be good to go. And so is, as you can tell, quarterback Quinn Smith. His knee just got a little banged up. So good news all around here on the sack sideline. Yeah.
All right, thanks, Caroline. On the first down play, Figueroa goes for just 1 to the 47. Second down and 9, 111, 110, 109, Smith. Wanting to throw, steps up in the pocket, fires a pass that is incomplete. The Sacks faithful are saying, where's the flag? They're wanting a pass interference call, but Cody, they're not going to get it. Or are they going to get it?
They actually got it.
Yeah, they did.
The official to our side made the call.
Late flag coming in, however, but yeah, they got it.
He shouldn't have been the one making that call, but nonetheless, it's called, and I believe that was a true pass interference, as it looks as though Sacks is going to get a fresh set of downs. And this would be huge. It is. It's about to be stepped off. And this is huge for Sacks. And Cleburne County with the miscue. That was a bad throw. And I don't know that he would have caught it anyway. And big first down for Sacks.
Yes, it is. Moves the football down to the 33-yard line. Just 106. 66 seconds remaining in the game. Sacks down by 7 with the football. And Smith to throw. Steps up. Eludes one tackler. Rolls far side. Pass caught, got it, 25-20, 15 down to the 14-yard line. On the receiving end of the toss once again, that was Ashton Scott, and Sacks is down inside the red zone.
And here we go. We see Quinn Smith step up in the pocket. He throws off of the would-be tackler, rolls out, and throws a nice strike to number 44. That's Ashton Scott for the catch for the Wildcats. Huge gain right there for the Wildcats.
45 seconds to go, Smith to throw. Now he reverses his field. He's got running room over there. He's still on his feet. Cuts back, throws into the end zone. Pass. It's caught. Penalty marker down. Penalty marker. There's two penalty markers down. Pass is caught for the touchdown, but they may bring it back.
This is going to come back. Quinn Smith was clearly across the line of scrimmage when he threw that. And that was a big play. He ran all over the field and made a nice athletic play, but I think he was right across the line of scrimmage when he released that football.
And I think the officials made the proper call. We'll get the official call from Jimmy Buckaloo in just a moment, but looks to be an illegal forward pass. That was the preliminary indication. And again, that due to the fact that Smith was across the line of scrimmage when he made that touchdown toss. So that will take the touchdown off the board.
Here we'll get the call from the Y hat, Mr. Jimmy Buckaloo.
And the Sacks already beginning to back up. 34 seconds is all that's left.
The illegal forward pass. The passer was past the line of scrimmage when he threw the pass. It's a loss of down foul, 5 yards. It will be second down.
Loss of down.
Loss of down. 5-yard penalty, second down now at the 18-yard line for Sacks. Smith to throw. Smith, pass here on the near side is well underthrown, intended for Scott. Incomplete, third down at the 18, 29 seconds to go. Are we having fun? Yeah, I think so. Just a half minute to go in this one. Sacks inside the red zone with an opportunity to possibly tie this game up before the final horn.
And this is a huge play. It's clearly, obviously, fourth down territory, but and it looks as though Coach Short is calling his final timeout. He's very frustrated about something.
And he gets his final timeout, and we will take one more break, and we'll be back with the conclusion of this one on the Friday Night Network.
Well, hey, you got one of those insurance apps too? You know how this thing works?
No, sorry. Not an app, it's my agent.
In this moment.
No, I'm fine, thanks.
It's good to know you have a trusted, independent auto owner's insurance agent who's there when you need them.
Great.
Man, I gotta get one of those.
Auto Owner's Insurance, the no problem people.
Calhoun Insurance in Oxford is your local independent auto owner's insurance agency.
What a ball game we've witnessed here this evening. Game of the week on the Friday Night Network. It will be third down and 15 for Sacks at the Cleburne County 18. Now they can get a first down at the 3. And again, Sacks has just 2 timeouts. Cleburne County has no timeouts. Michael Short just used his 3rd and final. Everybody on their feet at Jack Stewart Field. We're on our feet. Hey, you may be too. Here we go. 3rd down at the 18-yard line. Snap back to Smith, wanting to throw. With time. He's run out of time. Pass over there on the near side. It is caught. Powell's got it at the 11-yard line. That will be a pickup of 7. And quickly, Sachs calls a timeout with 19 seconds to go. We'll keep it right here. And that was Quay McCord. I think I said Powell, but Quay McCord on the receiving end of that one. And he picks up 8 yards down to the 11. So it will be 4th down and 8 at the 11-yard line. Let's set the stage now. Once again, they can get a first down at the 3-yard line. And they trail by 7. This, again, this football game here tonight, I mean, you're not going to be disappointed. No one that witnessed this one. It's for the Region 6 championship in Class 4A. The winner of this game will be the region champion. And two great teams like this, and kind of what we expected it. You know, we talked about it in the pregame. You know, it's a game that could go right down to the wire, and it has.
Jeff, this is if someone just watches the highlights of this game, they're not going to get anywhere near close as how good this game was. This is a huge 4th down situation for Sacks, and you got one timeout. Okay, they just changed it on the scoreboard. You're down, and there's 19 seconds left. You've got to score here. You're down by 7. And this is a huge play. This could end it for Sacks if they can't convert here. Let's see what they dial up.
3 wideouts to the left. Wideout, single wideout to the right. 4th and 8 at the 11. Smith rolls near side. Smith will run. Smith will not make it, but there's a flag down. We may have a face mask.
He almost ripped his helmet off, I believe, and that was huge as Quinn Smith is still laying on the ground. Sorry to interrupt you, Jeff. Go ahead.
No, you're fine. He was stopped well short of the first down, but we could see it, and I know you saw it, Cody, as well as me. That was an easy one to call for the officials, and it takes place on 4th down, and that will give Sacks another opportunity.
And that was just a bad mistake here by Cleburne County. As I know sometimes things like that can't be avoided, but as he was well short, as you can see, they spotted it about 4 yards short of the first down marker. And that's a face mask clearly, and that's going to be a first down. And they have a fresh set of downs inside about the 3-yard line. Once they step this thing off, it should be around the 3, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it's a tack-on penalty from the 8-yard line, and half of 8 is 4, so they take it to the 4-yard line.
Now the personal foul, face mask on the defense. It's half a distance to the goal. It results in a first down. First down.
And it's first and goal for Sacks. My goodness.
13 seconds here. You got to watch it. If you can't just string this play out too long, because you want to have time to run a couple of plays if you have to. With 13 seconds left, depending on how this goes, you got to have time to run a couple of plays. You got to think Coach Miller would call a timeout here if something were to go wrong.
And the fact they have a timeout, they could run the football here with Figueroa because they can stop the clock. You don't necessarily have to go to the air. Now the officials, and you see them right there, they're huddling over the football and discussing matters here. And we'll get this sorted out, I'm sure.
I'm not for sure why they brought the fifth official over to get into the huddle with them.
But it is a lengthy discussion that is taking place. And it was a personal foul face mask. and the penalty occurred at the 8-yard line, and the penalty was a tack on as Smith was tackled at the 8, and obviously you can't step it off 15. Let's see if Jimmy Buckaloo will explain things to us here, and then again he may just come over and talk to Coach Jonathan Miller, and that's what he's doing here.
Real quick, while he's doing that explanation, we just got a final in Class 3A Region 6. Glencoe has knocked off Weaver 15-14. So that was a huge win for Coach Osmond and the Glencoe Yellow Jackets to retain second place in Region 6 in Class 3A. As it looked like Weaver just shut out in the second half because they were up 14-3.
You can see the official talking to Jonathan Miller, and now the white hat will go to the other side, and now he'll reverse his field. He was about to go over and talk to Coach Michael Short, who, by the way, is waiting to greet Coach Short. And I tell you what it is. It is not an automatic first down. They have reset the chains. It is a personal foul. And from the 8-yard line, half the distance, moved the football to the 4. And they needed the 3 for a first down. So it will still be fourth down, but not an automatic first down. And that is the discussion. He initially ruled personal foul, automatic first down, but now they have corrected themselves. They've reset the chains, and it's fourth down and less than a yard at the 4-yard line. Not an automatic first down in high school. Well, what a way to end this one. Yeah, we'll take a timeout. We'll be back. Stay with us on the Friday Night Network.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all Ram trucks are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,700 on this 2015 Ram 1500 at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
And welcome back. And here we go. Fourth down, less than a yard at the 4. And the Sacks just used their final timeout. 13 ticks remaining. 2, possibly 3 plays, all that's left in this football game. But what's most important is Sacks must get a first down, and they just got an illegal substitution. They had 12 players on the field. And that's going to cost them 5 yards. They come out of the timeout. Their offense comes back onto the field, and their offense consisted of 12 players. And now it will cost them 5, move it back near the 9-yard line, and it will be 4th and 6. This final 20 seconds is taking a lifetime here.
And this is crazy. They're having personnel issues late in this ball game.
All right, ball game right here. Smith on 4th down, steps up. Smith looks under a lot of pressure, throws into the end zone, incomplete. This ball game is over. Cleburne County has come on the road and defeated Sacks. There's still 4 seconds remaining, but all Cleburne County will need to do is take a snap and kneel down, and they will be the Region 6 champions.
And just a heartbreaker for the Wildcats. Coach Miller's kids, they fought back after they had a few miscues. And with 4.9 seconds left, Cleburne County's just going to kneel this. And watch this as you see Quinn Smith gets the snap. He's got pressure coming up the middle. So he steps out there, rolls out to his right, and tries to throw a pass. But he's being brought down by number 7, Trevor Houston, and can't put enough arm on it. And a big win for Cleburne County on the road to clinch Class 4A Region 6, as they will be the Region 6 champions. And that's a huge win for them and a heartbreaker for Sacks here at home at Jack Stewart Field.
Sacks does not have any timeouts, and Swofford takes the snap, kneels down. The clock shows all zeros. And Cleburne County has defeated Sacks here this evening. At one time, they trailed 21-3 in this game. And they come back and win it. And again, I know we've said it a number of times here, but on the road, you come into Jack Stewart Field and you pull off a big one like this. And what a win for this Tiger program.
A huge win for Coach Short at Cleburne County, as this should move them up in the top 10. That's probably not to, that's no coach's worry where they're at in the top 10. They really don't care when it comes to getting ready for playoff time. And if you're Sacks, just put this one behind you, move forward. You've had a good season. You're still a good football team. You had some miscues. You got to go back to the film room, look at your mistakes. Some of these penalties, you know, both sides had some costly penalties, and Cleburne County comes out on top as a winner in this ball game, and it did not disappoint there for a second, Jeff. It looked as though this ball game was going to be all Sacks. Cleburne County comes roaring back. Sacks answers again. This is the best football game we've seen this year, and it's been a good one to call.
A rather bizarre ending to this one. Again, Sacks driving down all the way down to the 4-yard line and had a face mask call that was so big on that final drive. You had an illegal substitution call that was so big on this drive, and it got down to a 4th-and-6 at the 9-yard line with 13 seconds to go, and a 4th-down pass incomplete, and Cleburne County holds on in this one, and what a football game. Cleburne County moves to 7-1 on the year, but more importantly, they move to 6-0 in region play and are the Region 6 champions. One of the heroes for Cleburne County on that big pass interception return was Hot Sauce Jeremiah Blake, and he's standing alongside Caroline, so let's go to the field right now.
Yeah, guys, I'm down here with the MVP of the game. What was going through your mind when you caught that interception?
I just knew that, you know, our defense, we did what we were supposed to right then, and I was just in the right spot at the right time, you know, and,
No, go.
And, you know, I knew, I mean, I saw the pass coming. I saw him whenever he didn't go past the line of scrimmage. He ran back, so I tried to do what I could.
Your interception really turned the game around for y'all. Now you're regional champs. How does that feel?
It feels real good, you know, back-to-back. You know, with it being my senior year, it's a great feeling. You know, it's setting the standard for the next year's team.
Congratulations, Jeremiah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Guys, back to you.
Very much, Caroline. That's a happy young man right there, and what a play he made here this evening. And that might be one for the ages as far as Cleburne County High School football is concerned, a play they may never forget.
And as Jeremiah Blake said, this was huge. He talked about, I liked his answer there. He said, this sets the standard for the teams to come. This is his senior year, back-to-back region champs, and he knows what it means to build something and move forward to the future. And there's no shortage of talents. We've seen some of these young guys perform well, and Blake with that huge touchdown reception in the corner and then a pick six. So just a big night for him, and as they've named him the MVP of the ball game.
Let's take a break, and we'll be back to Jack Stewart Field. You're watching the Friday Night Network.
Tonight's FNN High School Football Game of the Week has been presented by Sonny King Ford and by Samco Express Marts. FNN High School Football is sponsored by Calhoun Insurance, Cycle World Power Sports, First Bank of Alabama, Food Outlet, and by Avery Auto Sales. Tonight's game has been brought to you by Aniston EMS, Wesley's Paint and Body, Cotton State Barns, K.L. Brown Memory Chapel, Glencoe Jewelry Sales, Cable One, and Skinner Body Shop. We'll wrap up tonight's game with highlights and more. Plus, look ahead to next week when we continue on FNN, the Friday Night Network.
Have you got the new car itch but don't want to take the plunge with a brand new car? How about getting the most car for the money at Avery Auto Sales? They have a large selection of cars with even some 2014s in the mix. And if you're worried about your credit, don't. They can help get you back on your credit feet with guaranteed approval. Check them out online at AveryAutoSales.net. Then when you see something you like, call them at 256-835-8897 for a test drive. Or just go by. Avery Auto Sales is located on Highway 78 East between Highway 78 and Snow Street in Oxford. That's Avery Auto Sales.
Well, hey, you got one of those insurance apps too? You know how this thing works?
No, sorry.
Need a place to keep your tools? or a place to get away from the wife. Whatever your needs are, we got a barn or a carport for you.
With rent-to-own options and no credit checks, we can help you take home the right barn or carport today.
And with four different locations, we're just a short drive away.
So come see us in Glen Cove, Moody, Asheville, or Atala, and let our family help your family get the barn or carport you deserve.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up before or after the game. With over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
Quickly back down to the field, Caroline with head coach Michael Short of the Tigers.
Coach, first, congratulations. That was a hard-fought victory that literally came down to the last seconds of the game. But now y'all are regional champs, so how do you feel about that?
Well, I'm so proud, really, just to be a part of this. You know, you have to give credit to both teams. You know, they got out to a 21-7 lead, and our kids never gave up. They never quit fighting. They never, you know, thought that we were going to lose. But, you know, what a heck of a game. It's just a heck of a game to be a part of, and we're just appreciative, and the good Lord gave us an opportunity tonight to win, and we stepped out tonight and grew up a little bit because we're going to have games like that in the playoffs.
Going into next week, y'all, you know, won the regional championship here. So what are you going to tell your guys to keep them focused?
Just the next game. That's just the way we are at Cleburne County. That tonight was just the next game. Next week is the next game because we know with a lot of the young players we have, we can still continue to improve. And if you stop improving, you're not going to do well in the playoffs. So our kids know we got to finish the region, you know, undefeated and in game 10. You know, it's just the next game.
Again, congratulations, Coach. Thank you. Guys, back to you.
All right. Thanks so much, Caroline. And that's a happy head coach right there, Cody. 18th year heading hip, his alma mater, again, defeating Sachs here this evening in come from behind fashion, 36-29. When you talk about highlights in this one, it is highlights galore.
And there you see the long run by Jason Henson as he had a couple of big runs tonight. And that was the big catch and run by Demetrius Powell as he took that one to the house. And this was a really good football game. I know it. The Cleburne County came roaring back, and it looked as though Sachs kind of lost a little bit there, but they turned it on late in the ball game and made this thing interesting.
And that young man had a big game as well, Figueroa, in a losing effort.
Figueroa with over 1,000-yard rushing coming into this game. He added greatly to that total because he did a great job here tonight. He left everything on the football field. All these players did, really. And after the summer that Cleburne County has had this year, it's I know Coach Short has to feel great about how this football season has gone, and they're undefeated, and it kind of shows why they should have their athletics program stick around for a little bit longer.
Yeah, what a big win, really, for not just the team, I mean the community as well, because this just, you know, they support them so much and have for so many years, and they just showed the fact that a lot of teams could just say, okay, this one's over when it was 21-3, but not Cleburne County. They kept fighting, and boy, it paid big dividends. What a play there by Blake.
And I like Blake. You know, he said he just saw the ball coming. He had to wait, and knew he had to make a play on the ball. It's something he knew he had to do as a senior, as a leader on this team, and he takes that one to the house for a touchdown. And I know Coach Short said that he just saw this as the next game, but you got to know, he knew in his mind, you know, this is the region championship. This is huge. Back-to-back region championships. And as far as keeping his team focused, he said they're used to just next game. But you know he's going to enjoy this tonight, him and his team and his staff.
Yeah, you know, a year ago, Cleburne County over Ellie Bell Field defeated Sachs 34-20. And then they come into the Wildcat House here tonight and win again. But, yeah, it's something special.
And for Coach Jonathan Miller, you got to build off of what happened tonight, fix some of those small mistakes. Sachs still a really good football team and a quality team going into the playoffs.
Again, the final score, Cleburne County wins it 36-29. For Cody Spoon, down on the field, Caroline Saunders, and the entire FNN team, thanks for joining us and good night.